national champions. Number one lives up to the billing. They defeat Purdue 75-60. They've done it again.
Put into words for me what it means to win back-to-back national championships.
It probably won't set in until you maybe get back on the bus, because your head's spinning right now. You didn't expect that type of game, but just what a dominant performance, and you're just so happy that that guys like Cam and Steph and those guys that have an experience in national championship now, they're going to get the ring, they're going to get the banner, they're going to get the whole thing.
Zach had 37-10. How'd you shut off the water for everyone else?
Well, we were willing to just kind of single it up the games that they've lost this year, they didn't get the production from Lawyer, Jones, Smith, and Giller. So, we wanted to take those four guys out. And if Zach went for 48 and those other guys didn't score, they didn't have a chance to win.
And lastly, after everything you lost last year, what makes this run and the manner in which you did win this so impressive?
I just think we're old school values, man, in terms of how hard we work, the type of people that we bring in. But we play modern basketball, and I think we've got a great formula right now for the people that we bring into the organization. And then, and I think we got a good formula with how we go about playing ball.
Congratulations.
Let's go, baby.
Dan Hurley and UConn get it done last night. 75-60, 15-point victory. As predicted right here on Out of Bounds. Joe nailed it. I nailed it. It's a win.
It was easy. They made it look easy. They always do.
My brother-in-law called me this morning. He's like, that was easy money, Wes. Good job. I was like, hey, don't thank me. Thank UConn. They made it easy on us. No sweating out, that 6.5 or 7.5, whatever you ended up getting. I like those kind of victories right there. Thanks to Bet Saracen for making that possible here in Arkansas. But it was impressive. The UConn defense, Joe. Defense wins championships. What they did, though, and Coach Hurley touched on it a little bit, they were going to let Zach Edey get his. They're going to make it as difficult as possible. But their plan, you don't let those other four guys score. I just added it up when he said that. 9 of 27. The rest of the team. You've heard that Edey scored 37 of their 60 points. So the rest of the team scored 23 points. 9 of 27 is what they shot from the field. That was just lockdown defense on the other four guys.
We talked about it going into the game that Purdue was impressive, and especially in that semifinal where they shot lights out from the perimeter. And then they had Zach Edey really involved in the game plan. But if you take one of those away, then that makes them less of a complete team and gives them less of a chance to win. And that was UConn's game plan. They did it to perfection.
Once again, great player has a very difficult time beating a great team. Saw it Sunday night. We saw it last night. The best team won that game. South Carolina won that game Sunday night. Last night, UConn win. Two great teams. Top to bottom. It's just not one individual player for either of the championship teams.
It was, like you mentioned, more about the defense, because we've seen Purdue have the same types of games that UConn has had, not on a consistent basis, but we've seen them against other competition dominate. So that says more about UConn in the way that they were able to not only dominate throughout this tournament, going back to last tournament, but then when they are facing another number one seed in Purdue, they still dominate them and just enforce their will on them like any other team.
Purdue made one three-pointer, 1 of 7 from the three-point line, and they came into the tournament, I think the second highest shooting percentage from the three-point line in all of college basketball this season. 1 of 7. So they're not giving up the shots, and then the shots they got were contested, 14% from the three-point line, and for the season they were around 40%. That's just focusing in, taking away the three, taking away the other guys, and playing some lockdown defense. Congratulations to UConn. That was impressive to see. And their offense is very good, too. Look, there was a reason they had the top offense in NCAA. It just goes together, hand in hand. It is hard to make a run against them because, A, you can't stop them from scoring, and then it's so hard to score. There were so many of those shots. Take away the Edey shot, and some of those were difficult shots. They made it tough on him. But the shots, the 9 shots that his teammates made, Joe, I bet there were five of them that I, when they made it, I was like, "Ooh, that was a tough shot. that was a tough shot." But hey, good shot. You know, that's how good their defense was all night long. Even when Purdue made, or some of Edie's teammates made a shot, they made it a very difficult shot and challenged it. We're going to talk more about the national championship game throughout the next 3 hours. Of course, the big topic is still John Calipari. Nothing new to say, but I can tell you, I've been talking to my same sources. Everything's okay. Of course,
it's a formality now.
Yes, we want it to happen. We want the announcement quickly. But his lawyers are looking at the contract and making sure everything's legit, and he has to sign it, and then Arkansas is going to announce it. Everyone fully expects that to happen today. I expect, honestly, a press release during the next 3 hours, during our show. I think we'll get it and get to talk about it officially, and then hopefully we get the details of a press conference. And everything that I've been told, it's going to be tomorrow. So we're just going to, as I tweeted out last night, relax. There was it all started, I think, on a message board in Kentucky. Then it went to Twitter, and it just exploded, Joe, for about 15 minutes of Coach Cal maybe looking to back out of his contract, maybe looking to back out of the deal, maybe looking to find a way to stay at Kentucky. And it just started spreading, and it was all over Twitter. And then I get text messages, and so I called my best source. I was like, "Hey, anything going on?" He's like, "No." I was like, "Are you sure? Because there's some bad rumor on there." And I was like, you know how it gets on Twitter, social media. And
it takes
Arkansas fans have that Dana Altman complex. You know, the coach is going to back out. So I get it. I understand it. People are worried. Nothing to worry about. He said, "No, everything's good. I can guarantee you everything is fine. Everything's fine." I'm like, okay, that's all I needed to know. So that's why I tweeted out last night to everybody to relax. And soon after, Brandon Marcello tweeted out that the details are expected to be worked out today, or, you know, last night he said tomorrow. And then Pete Thamel with ESPN also.
They were giving him credit nationally, saying that it was Pete Thamel and there was another
guy for ESPN. Here's the deal. While I broke the whatever news about it, those guys at ESPN, you know, broke the details of the contract 5 years. They had some details that I did not have. I'll admit that. They knew some other things that I wasn't privy to, and that's probably coming from the agents and the contacts that they have and whoever, whatever, it doesn't matter. So there were bits and pieces that they broke.
Were able to break, yeah.
And so that's what they're saying. They first, yeah, I'm fine. I don't care. I don't care. There are a lot of people from Arkansas. Every time ESPN says something or Thamel says something, and I'm mentioned in these tweets, and it shows up on my notification. Said, "Hey, you need to give credit to this guy. He's the one who broke it. You didn't break it." And you know,
that's
flattering and everything. But I honestly, it does not bother me. It not one single bit. It's done. It's in the past, and I'm just ready for Calipari to get this done. I'm ready for the press conference. I'm ready to start seeing who he's going to bring in, which players from Kentucky are going to follow him, which of the recruits are going to follow him. That's what I'm ready to move on to the next step. You know, they got the guy. Let's get it done. Let's move on to the next thing and start getting a team, because right now that roster is empty. And maybe there's somebody that played for Arkansas last year that Coach Cal really liked. He got two games against them, so he's got a good scouting report. Maybe there's one of those guys, or two, who knows, that he reaches out to and says, "Hey, if you want to get out of the portal and come back, I'd like you to be on this team."
And then with some of these other schools, the teams that have new coaches and the players that are in the portal there, if Calipari was recruiting these guys at Kentucky and it came down to Kentucky may have been one of their final teams, and we know that a lot of times players are committing to the coach, and now they're in the transfer portal, those are players that you start looking at also.
Coming up on the show today, Matt Zimmerman will join us at the top of the second hour. We'll get Coach Z's thoughts on this hire. We'll get his thoughts on on Coach Cal, the coach, and Coach Cal, the recruiter. Just see what Coach Z kind of thinks. And plus, got to talk to him about the Final Four. He was out in Arizona for a while. I don't know if he went to the championship game or not. I know he was out there Saturday and Sunday. So I don't know. He's in a meeting right now. He's been texting me. He's going to step out of that meeting and join us at 2 o'clock. So I don't know if he went to the game last night or not. We'll have to ask him, but I want to get his thoughts on the Final Four. And then also coming up, we've got our Masters giveaway. I'm excited. Let me check my phone. We're ready. Dusty Hannes is going to call in right now. I talked to Dusty yesterday, or exchanged texts with Dusty Hannes, and he's like, man, I'd love to come on. I'd love to talk about Coach Cal with you. So I was like, let's do it. And he is in Tel Aviv playing ball, and it's 9 hours ahead there in Tel Aviv. So there it's 10:18 there, 10:17 there. And last night, it was after the show, I was texting him. I was like, so it's like 1 a.m. there? And he's like, yeah, we're 9 hours ahead. And I was like, okay, well, if we can work it out, let's get it done. And we did get it done. And Dusty Hannes joins us now. How's it going, man?
Hey, how are you? Thanks for having me.
Oh, it's a fun time right now, Dusty, as you can imagine, in Arkansas with the news of John Calipari. When you first heard that news, what went through your mind?
I mean, just pure excitement, you know, like with a hire like that, you look at the floor and the ceiling of it. And I mean, our floor is just something incredible, you know, and the ceiling is national championships. Like just to have the whole state excited to make a hire of that magnitude, it's so big just for not only the program, but for our state.
Dusty, what do you remember about him and competing against him? And we know with competition, it brings out the best, you know, from a coaching standpoint, a player standpoint. What do you remember from some of those matchups?
That I couldn't beat them. It's the only school I couldn't beat. I mean, they just kicked my ass. So that's what I really remember about Calipari, is just having, you know, elite pros. Like my junior year, it was Jamal Murray from the Nuggets, was one of the big names. And then that senior year was Bam Adebayo, De'Aaron Fox, Malik Monk. I mean, just the talent level on the teams is just incredible. And just to know we're going to have that in Bud Walton, you know, like we got a little taste of it with, you know, Mus was bringing in some NBA guys at a high clip there for his tenure. And now it's going to be that and then some. So it should be really awesome.
So what do you think of the approach overall that has happened and kind of how college basketball has changed? Where Coach Calipari, he was known for that guy to bring in these highly recruited players that are, like you mentioned, NBA players. But the way college basketball has changed, now the transfer portal is a vital part of it. So how do you think that will all kind of work together where he is getting these highly recruited players from high school, and then you have the transfer portal there that you're able to lean on and get some quality players?
Yeah, I mean, it's such a different game than when I was playing and the previous years before that. But I mean, I know he'll figure it out. He's, you know, even with, you know, the young kids last year, you know, the tournament's crazy. They ran into a Oakland team that was on fire. You don't really know what happens if they get past that game. You know, Reed Shepherd was awesome. Dillingham was awesome. And you know, he had an older score in that Reeves kid. So, you know, I trust him with roster construction as much as I could trust anyone in the basketball world.
Dusty Hannes joined us on Out of Bounds. Glad to have him. Dusty, when you think of Arkansas basketball and the combination of Coach Cal, what is the potential?
I think national championship. I'm sure he's, you know, motivated with how it's gone for him at the end of his Kentucky run, like, which is, you know, kind of to me crazy that a program could ever let someone like that, you know, for just how big it is for us. And then just a few bad years in the tournament, how people can, you know, get stirred up about it. It's like Villanova with Jay Wright. I mean, I felt like every bracket I filled out for my whole life, they never were past the first weekend. And then back half, he gets back-to-back championships, you know? Like, the tournament's so wacky. He's just going to put us in a position to be in that tournament every year and have a chance to win the whole thing, and that's all you could ask for.
Dusty, I had to step away for just a second. I was doing some stuff in the background. Coach Calipari has just put out a video basically to Big Blue Nation, and he's saying goodbye. And we're working. We're going to get that after we get through with Dusty, and we're going to play it for everybody. But, you know, it's kind of that first confirmation from either Arkansas or Kentucky or Coach Cal that, you know, this is happening. So it's kind of some breaking news. I just want to let everybody know we're working on that. We're going to get that out for you. Just very exciting. Wow. Dusty, what are you doing? What are you doing in Tel Aviv?
Still playing. I signed for the rest of this season and the next two seasons. Honestly, love it here. Obviously, there's, you know, conflict in this area, always has been. But, you know, aside from that, it's literally one of my favorite places I've ever been in the world. I've been blessed enough to travel all over, and I really like it. I mean, it's kind of, I feel like I'm living like Miami, like weather-wise and just how the city is. It's good. It's really good.
What is how is safety? Do you feel safe there?
Yeah. I mean, like, in obviously the missile thing sounds insane for us coming from Arkansas. It's just crazy to even say for me right now. But, you know, in Tel Aviv, there's, I mean, probably been less than 5 deaths in the past 7 years from a missile. You know, so it's just the Iron Dome and the technology that this country has. I mean, you do feel safe.
What's the competition like there with some of the international players? And then are there some players that maybe you competed against that, you know, you've known for a while that are also playing in that league?
Yeah. The basketball world gets small once you get to, like, the elite domestic leagues over here. Because, you know, those are not many spots as well. So, like, Justin Smith, from the Hogs. He's on one of the good teams over here, and really just several. I mean, I feel like every team I play, I've at least competed against someone or played on the same team as them or something of that nature in most European games that I've played here in Australia. So it's cool. I'm still enjoying it a lot.
So what's the season like? How long, and, you know, what was that like? In, you know, trying to take that next step and maybe get back here to compete in the U.S.?
You know, for me at this point in my career, I don't even, like, have the I did my NBA chasing and probably did it a little too long, like, at least financially speaking. But, you know, I'm over here just taking it a day at a time and enjoying my, you know, if I'm lucky, you know, the next 2 to 5 years are my final days playing. So I'm just competing over here. And, you know, it's like a 10-month season in this country, nine and a half, and depending on if you win the championship. And, yeah, it's still fun for me. You know, as soon as it wouldn't be, I wouldn't be doing it. But I still really just enjoy the process and you know, taking care of my body and getting ready for games. And the feeling after good games has still not gotten old for me.
Okay, I'm trying to do the math in my head. You're 9 hours ahead of us. The game last night, the championship game, didn't start till 8:20.
8 hours.
Yeah, 8 hours. Okay, so that was like 4 o'clock, 4:30 in the morning for you. Did you wake up early and watch the game? Have you seen it yet?
No, I didn't make that one. I watched a little of the highlights. But yeah, as the tournament got, like, I was able to watch the first couple rounds because all the daytime games, you know, it was like perfect night times for me. But as the tournament goes on, it was all like 4 a.m. and 2 a.m. and I'm sound asleep.
How was it, the Team USA experience?
It was great, you know, just being around those people. Yeah, I'd done it the year before as well, and just getting around that group of guys and the ownership and administrators of that organization is just always awesome. They move first class, and we went to Havana, Cuba, where I'd never been before, so wow. I really enjoyed it.
Dude, that's pretty cool. I mean, the game of basketball is taking you around the world to places you probably never would have dreamed, and that's cool. That's awesome. Yeah. I'm very happy for you, Dusty.
I appreciate that.
And proud for you, too, man. And thank you for your time. That was generous of you to join us today and to get your thoughts on Coach Calipari. Hey, good luck to you, man.
Man, y'all too. Thanks for having me.
Dusty Hannes joining us on Out of Bounds. Pretty cool. All right, we've been working feverishly trying to get this Coach Calipari sound pulled up for you. We'll hammer that when we come back. Pretty cool. I got to listen just a couple of seconds of it, but it's basically he starts off by saying after a lot of thinking, they decide it's time for Kentucky to have a change of leadership. And so Coach Cal telling Kentucky bye. We'll play that for you when we come back. Stick around. It's getting fun around here. It's Out of Bounds.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
This is SportsCenter.
Last night, UConn beat Purdue 75-60, winning their second straight national championship. It was a team effort for the Huskies as four players scored in double figures, but they were led by Tristan Newton, who had 20 points, 5 rebounds, and 7 assists. He was named MVP of the tournament after the game. UConn won every game of the tournament by at least 14 points. Their average margin of victory in the tournament was 23.3 points. The last team to complete a back-to-back before them was the Florida Gators in 2006 and 2007. It is UConn's sixth national title, all coming in the last 25 years. They are a perfect 6-0 in the national championship game. And the Arkansas Travelers return to action today. They'll face the Tulsa Drillers with first pitch set for 7 o'clock. Coverage can be heard on 106.7 Buzz 2. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network. Join the Zone on location this Wednesday at the all-new Generator Supercenter, location on Chenal Parkway in Little Rock. Power up Arkansas with the number one generator dealer in the country. Get a free 10-year extended warranty and $1,000 off. The Zone on location Wednesday from the Generator Supercenter. Connor has cash. Once again, Connor has cash at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack in Conway. Connor will buy your used weapon, or he will buy your entire collection. Once again, Connor has cash, and he wants to buy your used weapons at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack, Highway 65 North in Conway.
It's Justin Aker from my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way, and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
RJ Hawk here with Chris Roberts from Southern Bank. And Chris, you know, we've talked so much about that hometown feel and what it's like at Southern Bank. But if you're a commercial investor, they need to come talk to you.
We're involved with a lot of customers that have projects across the United States. Those projects can be some of the biggest projects you would see in your communities. So really, there's no project that's too large for us to look at.
If somebody's interested in learning more about what Southern Bank can do for their commercial investments, how do they get in touch with you?
You just pick up the phone and call me at 501-424-0900. Just love to talk to you about your project, see what you've got going on, and see how we can be a help to you.
And you talk about being a help. You really invest into your commercial investors by helping them through the process, looking at things to look out for along the way.
I like to think we can throw things off of each other, listen to different viewpoints, and come to the best decision.
If you want to learn more, go online, bankwithsouthern.com, or call Chris, 424-0900, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
At Kubota, we want to help you deliver a job done right. That's why we want you to know that new Kubota inventory is arriving daily. You have work to do? We have the reliable, durable, and versatile lineup to help you do it. Visit River Valley Tractor today for all your equipment needs. Visit your local River Valley Tractor dealer, www.rivervalleytractor.com.
For over 30 years, Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse on 65th and University has been Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters and the only stop for all your truck parts and accessories. If it goes on a truck, Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse has it, like step bars, bed covers, toolboxes, and ladder racks, as well as gooseneck, fifth wheel hitches, and drop hitches. All this and more can be found at Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, a WeatherTech Diamond dealer, 501-568-0040, or online at arkansastruck.com. RSI.com and ask about the all-new RSI Smart Cap.
Tap Time with Bryce Nall and Scott Parton, presented by New Province Brewing, returns this Thursday at 7. Tap Time is Woodrock's premier radio show for beer lovers by beer lovers. Tap Time Thursday from 7 till 8 on 103.7 The Buzz, live from the Edwards Food Giant Studios.
Welcome back. It is Out of Bounds. Glad you're with us, Westmore. Joe Franklin. Fun day. So John Calipari speaks. We'll have that for you in a few moments. This is a lengthy video, so it's taking us almost 4 minutes long. So we got to record that and put it in the system, and we'll play it for you. Some details will soon start coming out. Let me check the email real quick. Nope, nothing from the University of Arkansas. Let me look over here on our text line real quick. Since we got started, that was cool to get Dusty on here. That was nice of him, you know, I guess it's almost 10 o'clock there. 10:30, that's 10:30, 9:30 there. Let's see here. 501 says Calipari released a statement to Big Blue Nation. Yep, we got it. We're working on that. Thank you. Kentucky AD. Yeah, there was a report that came out this morning that the voice of the Kentucky Wildcats had talked to their AD and said that Calipari had reached out to him to see if Kentucky would match their contract from Arkansas. I'm like, what? That doesn't make any sense. Because
if he wanted to do that, that would have been the first conversation. They would have done that from the start.
And the report is that Calipari hasn't informed him that he's been in discussion. That's been all over Twitter, that he hasn't been in discussion with a team, that it, per his contract, he's supposed to let Kentucky know if he has discussion with another school. So that something's not adding up there. And the reports are that, you know, he's making $8.5 million at Kentucky, and he also has a clause in there that if he retires, he gets a job with, you know, university making like $950,000 as an ambassador. Anyway, the report, maybe he's going to make more at Arkansas than that's being reported. But what I've been told, it's right around $8 million. So it's actually a little less than what he made at Kentucky.
But
so he's wanted them to match the contract.
Yeah.
I'm like, what is he matching? To take a decrease in salary? So I didn't like that report. I didn't buy into that report at all. Let's see what apparently his future. He needs to reach out to Ty Robinson from Lake Hamilton. His future coach at FAU took the Michigan job, and Robinson reopened his recruiting a couple weeks ago. I hope Robinson can go to Michigan. That would be a cool move for him, too. Fantastic player. Got to watch him in high school at Lake Hamilton. Guy can go, man. I was excited for him to get to go to FAU, but now with that change, he has reopened his recruitment. Cal has no agent, has Tom Mars. Yeah, he's his kind of advisor when it comes to an attorney. Calipari 5 minutes ago, yep, we got it, we're doing it. You guys are all over it. That's not very nice. I'm not reading that. Go Monk, go. Okay, this one from Willie and Sardis. Kentucky can't handle the breakout with making it look like they were the ones that made the decision. You know, last night I did a podcast for a Kentucky group of guys that covers Kentucky basketball, and they were awesome guys, by the way. And they mentioned a couple of them were they felt like it was time to go. One of them is a huge Cal fan, and he said in an ideal situation, he wanted it all to work out with Calipari and for him to be the coach, but to be winning. But, you know, he hasn't been winning, so he understands, you know, why this needs to happen. And he said, ideally, he would like to really for Cal just to step away, retire, and not coach again, or if he went to somewhere, not to go to an SEC school, go somewhere else. But they kind of felt like it was time for a change and this was a good move, but they also felt like this was a good move for Arkansas. And they were worried that, you know, this could rejuvenate Calipari and get him going again and have that chip on his shoulder, and you might see the Calipari of old, like Kentucky got when he first got there and the success he had his first 6 years at Kentucky.
The guy has still been the same coach. It's just that the teams haven't achieved what they set out to do. It's not that he's coaching different, that he doesn't have fire anymore. It's just about postseason success. We see that he continues to put talented teams on the court, and they have that same type of blueprint where they may start off a little bit slow because they're all young guys working together for the first time, and then they get better as the season goes on. Then ultimately you're judged by success in the tournament. They haven't had that recently.
If you want to jump in here, now's a good time. 501-366. No, I almost gave my phone number.
501-661-1037.
Things are kind of whirling around in my head. It's kind of crazy right now. How that would have been awful to give out my phone number on the air. How brilliant was it to leak the information about all the NIL money Cal is getting? Completely froze the top of the portal. Guys that were about to sign were like, whoa, hold up a second. That's from the 870, and that is a good point. That and the name, Calipari. They know this is an opportunity, and things are – and it's not just Arkansas that's opening up. It's Kentucky, too. And so they don't want to make a rash decision before all this plays out. And so I do think it is wise for anyone in the portal to hold off and let this play out. Because here's another thing. Richard Davenport's told us this a couple of times. You can't come back and do in-campus visits until Thursday. Now, a lot of these portal guys do Zoom meetings and Zoom tours and don't necessarily take visits, but some of them do. And this is something that if I was in the portal and Calipari was leaving and going to Arkansas, and yeah, I would hold up too. So I think that's a great point from the 870. Chick Jack says, all this Calipari to Arkansas talk still seems like April Fool's joke. It's not. And I will tell you, Sunday night when I tweeted it out, a lot of the comments that I got in the replies were, Wes, you know April Fool's was last week. And look, I couldn't respond to everybody because of how crazy that night was. But it's no joke, and it's going to happen. Wes, I'll never forget that you told me Calipari will be our coach. That's Eddie from Amity. Well, thanks, Eddie. I'm glad you were following along. Wes, this is my problem with Cal and Kentucky. All right, let me know what your problem with Cal and Kentucky is. Tubby won a title in 98, then he was run out of town for the result his next 9 years. How did those 9 years compare to Cal's last 9 years? Well, Tubby was a little bit better. Higher winning percentage, better in the SEC tournament, better in the NCAA tournament, had 3 Elite Eights compared to 2 for Cal, and never missed a tournament. Tubby never missed a tournament for Kentucky, whereas Cal missed one tournament for Kentucky. And I'm not saying, look, the Calipari of the last 4 years, 2021, 22, 23, 24, those results, there's no sugarcoating. There's no debating. I mean, we've talked about those results. I think they're 2-6 in those last four tournament appearances with first-round exits to Oakland and St. Peter's. That's why he was on the hot seat. That's why there are people in Kentucky that aren't sad to see him go. That's not the Calipari Arkansas wants. They want a Calipari that's got something to prove. That's what my hope is, that's the Calipari that they get.
Well, you're talking about a guy who hasn't forgotten how to coach. He's somebody that he still recruits these players at a high level. That's the first part of it. You have to get the players in. And then, you know, from there, you take them and try to develop them. Now, he has been getting top-caliber talent where a lot of these guys, after 1 year, they're on to the NBA. And that's not his fault. That's one of those things with, you know, there's all the concern about the transfer portal, NIL, but there's also a concern with, on the other hand, where the NBA, they need to change certain rules to allow these guys that don't want to have to go to college, they shouldn't be made to go to college. And there are other options out there, but for the ones that go to college that have to be a year removed from high school, then they have a dream that they're trying to fulfill, and they're not going to stay in school any longer than they need to.
From the 501, so Wes, what is exactly the holdup to no announcement? How long does it take? I guess it takes about 48 hours. I mean, not trying to be a smart aleck, but it takes time. I mean, I think Arkansas has taken the position that they want to get this not only just finalized, but the deal signed, the ink on the paper, before they make an announcement. They want to make completely sure, because sometimes these coaches will agree to a new contract, and that contract isn't signed for a while. I mean, it's a different scenario because Chris Beard is the acting head coach at Ole Miss, but, you know, he didn't sign that agreement that I think they announced it in the SEC tournament. He just recently signed that. But he had it for a couple of weeks, but his lawyers were looking at it. It just takes a while. When lawyers get involved and people are looking over the contract, it's not just a cut-and-dry type thing. There could have been something, and I'm just throwing this out there, there could have been something in the contract that Cal's attorney looked at and said, hey, I don't like this wording. I don't like how they kind of put this in here for whatever case it may be, because we know there are incentives in the contract. And they may not like that clause and said, hey, we don't like the wording on this. Can you rewrite it? So Arkansas's like, yeah, and their attorneys have to get in. And then they rewrite it. Then they have to send it back. Then the lawyer. So it takes time. And, look, I know we all want this to happen, and it's hard to have patience. And with the past history of Dana Altman, you worry about things. But I don't think it's anything whatsoever, because Cal is working behind the scenes right now. I've already been told that. That he's working on his staff. He's working on recruiting. He's working on, you know, his current players. He's working on guys that have signed it. And he's not just walking his dog all day long, people. Okay, there are a lot of things he can do in Kentucky at his house that he can do anywhere. Nothing to worry about. Let's go and take a couple calls real quick. I said we'd take some calls. Rebecca is up first. What's up, Rebecca?
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Wes, I want to commend you. I would never have believed it. I saw the rumors on Twitter. But because it was you who put it out, I believed it. Because I know you don't put anything out unless you've got a verified source.
Thank you. I made sure I had three on this case. This was too big to just have one source. I made sure.
I know.
I triple sourced this thing.
I said, when I looked at that and I did a double take, I said, well, Wes ain't going to put it out there unless it's true. So he must know something the rest of us don't know. And I think all the Hog fans that were dissing Hunter Yurecek owe him a big apology, because that dude was out there playing chess while everyone else is playing checkers. I mean, he hit a home run. And I have a question. This is because I've heard it pronounced two different ways. Is it Calipari, Calipari?
Calipari.
Perry. Okay. Like, you can either in your mind think of a pair of socks. Me, I think of the fruit, the pear. Because when there's a pear tree next to our house, and I always think of a pear. So it's Calipari.
That's what I was thinking. But like I said, I've heard him call him Calipari, so I wanted to get it straight from you, because I knew you would know, so.
Rebecca,
anyway,
thank you for the call. Have a great day.
Love the show. You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks, Rebecca.
Joe and I actually had that conversation yesterday. We said we're going to have to start the movement to let our listeners know it's Calipari, and to be nice and correct people when they say the other way. I don't want to say the other way. I don't want to even put it out there anymore. It's like the Milmaid guy. I don't even want to talk about Milmaid anymore, ever. It's Calipari.
It's important to say people's names right. That's important.
Yeah, we went through that with Isaiah Satania. We went with that with Caliph Battle. I think we called Caliph Battle Caliph for about 3 weeks. Who else? Oh, Vahivo Loy. We had to do that with Dave Van Horn, remember? We still got it over here.
That one didn't take long at all.
No, well,
it's just, you know, it's spelled one way, but it sounds a different way.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple.
No. So, we'll get that one right. Jake, he's in Cabot. What's up, Jake?
Hey, Wes, what's going on, man? I owe you that six-pack of Yingling, and when I am in town and can swing by there, I promise you I'll make good on that, all right?
I know you will. I'm not worried about it. I'm just happy that the Razorbacks won, and then I won my bet on Saracen. That's, you know, that's the one that really mattered.
Hey, have you realized that all our coaches in the major sports have, like, short names? Coach Pitt, Coach Cal,
DVH.
Coach Buss, DVH.
We do that with everybody, though.
I don't know.
Is Jake your real name?
Or a lot of people call him Dave, too, man.
Yeah. Is Jake your real name?
Yes, sir, it is.
But
that's
my
given name, not Jacob.
It's not Jacob. Okay. That's what we do. We shorten all names. I'm a Wesley, but I'm Wes, you know? Are you a Joseph, Joe?
Yeah.
Nope. Yeah, I am. But I mean, I'm that way, though. I shorten everybody's name.
Yeah.
So I'll say to somebody, if I shorten their name and that's not what they prefer, let me know.
Mm-hmm.
So I can say it the way you want me to say it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Petrino, I think, is the only one that's not shortened. But if you think about it, I mean –
Bob.
BMFP, you know.
Yeah, there
are. Anyway.
His friends are calling Bob.
I'm stoked about this hire. I think, I want to echo Rebecca, and I don't agree with her a lot, but I will say this, man. The fans didn't get off of Yurich's back. Like, he has knocked it out of the park twice in a row now. And this guy knows what he's doing. And let him do his thing. Let him run the athletic department. And let him, you know, build Arkansas back into a contender in every sport that we can possibly contend in. And with that, I'll let you guys go. I just want to hear any thoughts on the game tonight, or is there any chance of it being canceled because of weather? I don't know. I'm up close to St. Louis right now, but I was looking at the radar earlier and it looked kind of gnarly.
Yeah.
So, love you guys. Love the show. Love you, Joe. Look forward to seeing you again, Wes. Look forward to meeting you, bro.
See you,
Appreciate
Jake.
It, Jake.
Be careful out there. Yeah, I looked at the future radar for tonight in Fayetteville. And they should be getting some rain this afternoon. And it seemed to break up and look good for 6 o'clock in this evening before rain returns around midnight. So I think they'll play baseball. We've always been told that field drains very well, and I'm sure they have it covered right now, the infield. So I'm expecting baseball tonight. Tomorrow, Joe, I'm a little worried because there's a 50% chance of rain all throughout the afternoon tomorrow. And they're supposed to play a 3 o'clock game tomorrow. Is that right?
Yes.
Pre-game at 2:30, so it would be an abbreviated out of bounds.
Once we pass it to them, we're good, but we need to be able to pass it to them.
That's all we have to do is pass it off?
Yeah, that's it.
Like, it's a relay race, and we're coming, and we hand off the baton, then we're out the door?
Yes.
And then it's up to them?
Right. But we need to be able to pass it off.
I can pass well. I can do that to Phil. Here you go, Phil.
At Shelter Insurance, we believe insurance should adjust to fit your needs. We work to design an insurance plan that's particular to you. Insurance that fits just right. And Shelter Insurance ranked number one in customer satisfaction among auto insurers in the Central Region 5 out of the last 6 years by J.D. Power. Satisfied customers and a plan for you. Ready to check us out? For J.D. Power award information, visit jdpower.com/awards.
For auto, home, life, or business insurance, see Shelter Agent Stephen Elmore, 501-537-0959.
It's Justin Acri for Kauffman by Design West. Shop with the local folks and get exactly what you want. You can also shop from the convenience of your own home by going to kauffmanlumber.com. There's an online store with over 800,000 items in inventory that can be delivered straight to your front door. Items in inventory include everything from hardware to housewares, heating and cooling supplies, lawn and garden tools, sporting goods, store and office supplies, and there's a huge range of products in each area available. So go by their store in West Little Rock at 14900 Cantrell Road or do your shopping online at kauffmanlumber.com.
Fellas, there's a lot of people out there talking about testosterone, but you got to make sure you do your homework, man. You got to make sure you go to a provider that you can trust. I recommend Low T Center. It's where I got my levels checked 6 years ago, and we're going strong today. At Low T Center, they make it quick and easy. You walk in, you take a simple blood test, and you'll get your results back in about 25 minutes. If you've been feeling tired, grumpy, maybe you've noticed weight gain, loss of muscle mass, you may have low T levels. Go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment online. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. Hey, everybody, it's RJ Hawk. You know, I've been talking about this for a long time, and I say the future's here. You just haven't tried it yet. If you've got achy joints that have been nagging you for a long time, don't go to a doctor and have them recommend surgery or drugs. Go by and give QC Kinetics a try today for a free consultation. They are the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades. It's called regenerative medicine. If your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. We're talking natural biologics using your own body's power to repair and restore your damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Shinecup. He is a pioneer in the field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. Call QC Kinetics now to learn about these exciting options. It's a free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Yo, remember back on the bully when cats used to harmonize like...
Yo. Welcome back. Glad you're with us. Out of Bounds, Westmore, Joe Franklin. All right, we told you earlier, Coach Cal put out a message to Kentucky fans on Twitter. We got it for you. Here's Coach Cal.
Since our season ended, Ellen and I have spent a lot of time thinking about our time here at Kentucky. What it means to us, the friends we've made. On that court, regional championships, conference championships, Final Fours, the national title in 2012. It's been a beautiful time for us. This is a dream job. It was my dream job. Anybody in our profession looks at the University of Kentucky in basketball and said, that is the bluest of blue. The last few weeks, we've come to realize that this program probably needs to hear another voice, that the university as a whole has to have another voice giving guidance about this program that they hear, and the fans need to hear another voice. We've loved it here, but we think it's time for us to step away and step away completely from the program. There have been opportunities that have been presented to us, and we're discussing them as a family. I love coaching. I love coaching young people. I love this year's team. I loved every day walking in. They've invigorated me. I love the chase for championships. I love bringing the kids together. It's what I do. It's who I am. Let me start, though. I've got to thank the players and the families that I've had the privilege of coaching because they've entrusted me with their son and their son's career. What they've done in the classroom, Over 30 of the guys have graduated, 6 in 3 years. What they've done in this community to give back to the state of Kentucky. They gave all of us everything they had on the basketball court and off the basketball court. And I am indebted forever until the wheels fall off. And I think they all know that. I'm not going to bring up names because if I bring up one, I've got to bring up 50. And lastly, thanking staff, all the people that worked to help us have the success we've had. All the people in the university as a whole in all the things that they did. The friends, I'm looking right into the camp. We've made lifelong friends that we'll be close with the rest of our lives. And the fans, the BBN, all that you've done to build this program, the people that traveled with us, I want to thank you. Hopefully it was an experience with your kids that you can look at and say, man, this is something that we'll remember the rest of our lives together. Those memories and what we were able to do together is what this is all about. Again, it's been a dream what we've been able to do. But 15 years, time for another voice. And you know I'm always going to be a fan. Thank you.
Coach Calipari, a message to Big Blue Nation. And before you even start, let me answer it. Why didn't he mention Arkansas? Why did he say we're looking at other opportunities? This was a message to Kentucky fans. He did what he should have done there. This is all about his time at Kentucky. This was his way of saying goodbye to Kentucky.
No need to mention Arkansas there.
He'll have a time to talk about Arkansas. That time is coming. This was a time to say goodbye. So I completely agree. I think he did it the right way. I'm not upset he didn't say Arkansas. Say goodbye. And you know what? We'll say hello tomorrow. Hour number two is coming up next on Out of Bounds. Coach Z will join us, Matt Zimmerman, and we're going to give away some golfers for our Masters contest. I got the details on that coming up. It's Out of Bounds.
Registration is open for the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course, presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka.
Connor has cash. Once again, Connor has cash at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack in Conway. Connor will buy your used weapon, or he will buy your entire collection. Once again, Connor has cash, and he wants to buy your used weapons at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack, Highway 65 North in Conway.
I am an athlete.
I am an educator.
I am an EMT.
A neurologist.
A veteran.
A business owner.
I'm a mom.
We are survivors.
Cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of women and doesn't discriminate.
It can affect any woman at any age or stage.
Yet many women don't know it's our greatest health threat.
Encourage three women you love to learn more about their risk factors and how they can take charge of their health today.
If you are looking for a safe and loving home for you or your loved one, visit Heartland Rehabilitation and Care Center. Just 15 minutes from Little Rock and Benton, our skilled nursing staff is dedicated to providing quality long-term care and short-term therapy. Visit heartlandrehabcenter.com. You can call Heartland home.
It's where the big boys come to play.
This is madness! This is Sparta!
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Funeral arrangements are still being made for Shorter College president Jerome Green. Green died on Monday. He was 69 years old. Green was appointed the 45th president of Shorter College in 2012. He earned his doctorate at the University of Arkansas at Little Rock in the School of Law. In addition to acquiring a bachelor's at Miles College, he would work there and the Arkansas Ethics Commission before becoming president at Shorter College. We'll keep you updated as soon as we know more. In Russellville, love was in the air during the eclipse as couples from 22 different states got married all at the same time. The ceremony happened just before the solar eclipse reached totality across Arkansas, giving the couples a chance to experience that as husband and wife. We spoke with one couple who says they've been together for several years, and when they saw this chance arise, they said, why not, and signed up to elope. The ceremony lasted 13 minutes and was officiated by one person who married all of the couples just before the solar eclipse entered totality. From the Channel 7 newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
It's the Average Guy Movie Review, Thursdays in the Zone with Justin and DJ, presented by Rock and Roll Sushi. The guys will recap or look ahead to what's trending on TV, the big screen, Netflix, or however you receive your TV service. Presented by Rock and Roll Sushi, deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that will blow your mind. RockandRollSushi.com.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Rain and thunderstorms likely today, a little bit cooler too, with a high of just 67 degrees. More rounds of rain expected Wednesday and early Thursday. A few strong storms possible, but definitely some heavy rain. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Roger Scott here. Let me remind you about my friends at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union. They have some of the most aggressive auto loan rates for Buzz listeners in Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. Easy access to Alcoa's team of loan officers online, by phone or in person at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union's two locations in Benton and Sheridan, and apply online at alcoacommunityfcu.org.
It's Justin Aker for Serta Pro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year, I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get Serta Pro Painters on the case today. SertaPro.com, that's Serta with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right, because they take pride in what they do. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
This is the Pigskin Preacher, bringing you the word. Alyssa Milano's acting career has earned her an estimated net worth of $10 million, which makes her recent actions of soliciting funds on social media for her son's baseball trip to Cooperstown rather puzzling. When you're worth $10 million, it takes a lot of nerve to ask strangers for $10,000. In a time when many are struggling to pay their bills. Unbelievable. Gandhi once said, "There is a sufficiency in the world for man's need, but not for man's greed." Maybe someone should explain this to Milano. Doubleby's has such good prices that you won't need to launch a GoFundMe to afford the things you want to buy. Fuel, food, fun, it's all waiting for you at Doubleby's. Because Doubleby's is where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Doubleby's.
Willie D's Rock and Roll Piano Bar, open every Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Cold drinks and dueling pianos. Deep Nightclub downstairs hosts karaoke on Tuesdays and DJ spin on Friday and Saturday nights. Visit WillieD'sPianoBar.com. Come
and
get your Willie on.
And ESPN Radio Extra Point. With Amber Wilson.
It's understandable from NATO's perspective because it would be pretty cool, first of all, to be able to be the coach that wins the first national title there at Alabama. You're already at a major program, obviously, in a major conference. But even more than that, you're making major money if you're NATO's. Right now, he's making $5 million a year. By the end of this latest extension, he'll be making almost $8 million a year. So you're making almost Kentucky-level money. You're making football money. You're making almost Kentucky-level money. And yet, a lot less pressure and the ability to do something that's never been done before at that university. I would imagine Nate Oates is having a lot more fun right now at Alabama also. And frankly, I weirdly think it helps Nate Oates that Nick Saban left in a way, because now Nate Oates is the big man on campus, right? Like, it's Nate Oates' world and everybody else is just living in it. We'll see what happens there with that football program. Of course, that could change.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. 120,000 miles of night drives, daily commutes, and who knows how many.
Are we there yet?
Through countless fixes, elbow grease, and a new radiator, you kept your ride alive. With eBay Motors, you have over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Lowe's knows pros need the right tools for every job. That's why we sell the largest in-store selection of Klein tools anywhere. Find new items like the self-leveling green laser level for just $159.98. Plus, shop the Connect pass-through socket set for $49.98, which you can only find at Lowe's. Shop Klein tools in-store and online today, because Lowe's knows tools. Lowe's knows pros.
Live from the Signal Media Studios, this is Out of Bounds with Wes Moore and Joe Franklin on 103.7 The Buzz. It's time for your Razor Hog update on Out of Bounds. Brought to you by Floyd's Seafood, Keele Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season. Floyd's Seafood has live and cooked crawfish. Order yours today.
I apologize for that delay. That was not my fault. My page was stuck over here, Joe. I couldn't get it off the thing. I thought I was going to have to reset the computer. It was stuck on daily, and I couldn't get it on segments. That's why I was waving. I was like, dude, I don't know what's going on over here.
I didn't see a wave.
I don't know what I did. I just started hitting things. All right, Razorback report right now for you. John Calipari on his way to Arkansas. He said goodbye to Kentucky today. Still have not received – well, before I say that, let me do one more check. Still have not received an official email from the University of Arkansas, but I'm expecting it any moment now. Also, the Diamond Hogs are in action tonight. They take on San Jose State. That is a 6 o'clock game today. They'll turn around and play tomorrow, weather permitting. We got our fingers crossed that they'll play tomorrow afternoon at 3. There are supposed to be some scattered showers in that area tomorrow. The softball team, one of the biggest risers. No, they are the biggest riser in the poll. They moved up 5 spots after knocking off number 11, Missouri, this past weekend. The weekend before, they knocked off number 3, Georgia, taking 2 out of 3 in the series. So congratulations to them. And I think that's it. I think that's the best part of the Razorback news that we have for you. We got Matt Zimmerman, fresh off of an appearance at the Final Four, hanging out with all the coaches there. I know after talking with Aaron Torres, there was quite a buzz around Phoenix in the Final Four about John Calipari and Arkansas, and the rumors were flying there. But I want to get his thoughts on the Final Four games. And then, of course, the game last night where UConn gets it done once again and goes back-to-back, and he knows how hard it is to go back-to-back. They completed this. I heard it on the radio last night. That the teams that have gone back-to-back, and what is it, there's like 6 or 7 on whatever the number is, I'm not sure. But each team that went back-to-back won the second game in their back-to-back by double digits. That trend continued again last night, of course, with UConn winning by 15 points. But I was like, that would have made me even feel better about my bet on Bet Saracen if I would have known all the teams that had gone back-to-back, won their game by double digits. And that's something UConn had been doing, well, the entire tournament. That just seemed like a no-brainer to me. I mean, they're beating everybody by double digits. The best of the best in the NCAA tournament for 2 years in a row. They're just beating everyone handily. Let's bring in Coach Matt Zimmerman. He joined us on Out of Bounds. Coach, what's up? How are you?
Oh, what's up, guys? Good to be on with you as always. And I'm talking to the conquering hero, Wes Moore. That's an honor.
Get out of here.
And Joe, it is good, always good to be on with y'all. And it's exciting. I'm always excited about Razorback basketball, but boy, it sure is exciting right now. It's coming off of a losing season. It's if you'd have told me 2 weeks ago how excited everybody would be over Razorback basketball, I'd be like, how? How would we be excited, this excited? So it is really something that's pretty neat.
You know, it's not official yet, And so it's tough. I don't want to put you in an awkward position. And so our conversation will be if this happens with Coach Cal. What would that mean? Because look, the excitement is because people believe he's coming, and you know, and I 100% believe it's a done deal, and he's on his way literally right now to Arkansas. And he did say goodbye. I don't know if you've seen it yet. Coach Z, Coach Cal said goodbye to the Big Blue Nation. He tweeted out a 3-4 minute video earlier, about an hour ago. But anyway, if Coach Cal comes and is the next head coach at Arkansas, what would be your first thoughts?
Well, obviously, it's a huge deal. When you talk about college basketball, all you know, the players are the ones that are on the floor. They change every year. And the coaches, the ones that make it their life, stay. And there's really no bigger name in college basketball than his name. And if he does end up here, like all, you know, people are reporting, if that does happen, it's the biggest name in college basketball coming to work for the Arkansas Razorbacks. And we've had some high-profile coaches before. Eddie Sutton was very high-profile. But at the time, he wasn't the number one name in college basketball. Nolan Richardson was very high-profile, won a national championship. You know, maybe for a little bit of time, he was up there, one or two or three talked about. But for the guy that's been around, done it a long time, 15 years, you know, the Razorbacks went against him when he was at UMass, and he beat us. He beat us a couple times, once in the NCAA tournament. Memphis games and all the tradition that he established with Memphis and getting that program, they were tough in the Conference USA when Conference USA was loaded. And he's been to 6 Final Fours. They took a couple from him, but so he's got 4 officially on the books. And what I love, what I respect about him is that the conference championships, and really, we used to always chase conference championships at Arkansas. And I know that's not what nobody worried about. Everybody wants, hey, we want to win national championship. But it's also nice to win SEC championships. And he won 6 of them, and he won 6 SEC tournaments. There was a I coached was on staff here with 2 really good teams. One of them had 27 wins and a first-round draft pick, Bobby Portis. We still couldn't win the conference tournament. We would lose in the finals to his Kentucky teams. And so if Coach Cal does end up being the head coach at Arkansas, he brings a lot of winning success. And then you can see it. And he's a national championship coach. He's been in the Hall of, he's in the Hall of Fame already, has been in the Hall of Fame for a long time. And that 38-0 team he had, that lost to Wisconsin, that was one of the best college basketball teams I ever coached against. And the other one that I think is the best college team that I ever coached against was our first year at Arkansas, 2011-12. And I was an assistant at Arkansas, and we had to go to Rupp and play Anthony Davis and crew. And those were the 2 best college teams that I ever coached against. And we coached against a lot of great Kansas and North Carolina and Duke teams, all of them. The 2, I think, the best I ever went against were 2 his Kentucky teams.
Coach, the excitement started once Arkansas had a vacancy. Of course, you know, Coach Musk had plenty of success at Arkansas. But once that opening became available, then, you know, the next step is everybody's thinking, what is next? Who's going to be next? So with the potential that's there of Coach Cal coming in, that kind of put the excitement on another level for – a lot of people just thinking, what could
be? Yeah, you're right, Joe. And, you know, Wes and I, we've talked about this before. Kevin Trainer always talks about it here at the university. Chuck Barrett talks about, you know, Razorback fans want to win, period, and they're consumed with it. But when you talk about a coaching search, it's another level. And it has been my whole life. From the time Eddie Sutton said, I'll crawl to Lexington, that coaching search. You know, and you kept up with it back then. No social media. You kept up with it in the newspaper.
Yeah.
You know, and watching the 6 o'clock and 10 o'clock news to see if if Paul Ills mentioned a different name or a new name on the news and sports. And you know, now it's even escalated. Even it's incredible. And you know, last Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday was wild. Thursdays when Coach left, I had 60. I went back through. I was keeping it on a piece on this paper, his legal pad, and several pages of a legal pad, 62 phone calls that I talked to. Some of them were for a minute, some of them was national media calling, asking if I knew anything, and some of it was friends and relatives and just everybody at the University of Arkansas, and 62 calls. And then Friday and Saturday and Sunday, I was at Final Four, so I wouldn't write anything down, but just countless calls, even talk to Wes. And, you know, there's just so much going on with the coaching search and all the rumors. And I did get to talk a little bit to Hunter yesterday during the Eclipse thing up at the football stadium. And, he's always got incredible stuff coming out of coaches' searches. I sure can't share that with you because he'll have a press conference tomorrow and he might talk a little bit of some of that. But Hunter had a whirlwind few days. He did go to Phoenix to the Final Four, and then he came back, I think, on Friday. And he had a busy time. And I think that he did a great job. And to get Coach Cal, or if he does get this done, and Coach Cal is the head coach at Arkansas, which we all hope at this point, that's a huge deal for any athletic director.
Talking with Matt Zimmerman. He joins us on Out of Bounds. Coach, you've been on the opposite end of the floor as Coach Cal, as a coach. Mm-hmm. A lot of people think of him as a great recruiter, and he is. But as a coach, what is his strengths as a coach? What's he bring to the table?
Well, he's got this big personality. He's not a big screamer and yeller and go. Well, he does do that too, but he's got a big personality. He's just one of those guys, Wes. I can remember going to my first meetings at the Conference USA tournament in 2002, 2003. And, you know, it's Rick Pitino at Louisville and Bob Huggins at Cincinnati and Cal at Memphis and all these other coaches, Houston and all the teams in our league. And he just had a presence about him. And you always know when he's in a room. And back in those days, he was always dressed super nice and slick. And he was a slick-haired guy. He had the dark hair back then, and he just had a presence about him, and he was always around. Seemed like he was always around very important people, and they were around him, and he had their attention. And he did a great job at Memphis. We played his teams twice a year and played him in the Conference USA Championship game one time in Memphis, unfair, and they beat us and at the FedEx Forum, and then coached against him a lot. One of my favorite memories is in 2009. We had a Missouri team that was school record 31 wins, and we upset Memphis in the NCAA tournament. It was one of my top five favorite wins in 25 years of coaching, beating his teams. And, you know, I think we played him, I was trying to count him yesterday, I don't know, 22 or 23 times over the years. And he's a good coach. His teams are usually big. They usually rebound very well. And he's going to get extreme talent. He's always going to have high-level players. Not that he's not trying to develop them, but he's going to go get those Bam Adebayos and Sage Gilgeous Alexander and Willie Cauley-Stein and Carl Anthony Towns. And I mean, when we played with Bobby Portis, we go to Kentucky and Booker's coming off the bench. Devin Booker, one of the best players in the world, you know, is coming off the bench. And he has had so many great players at Kentucky. And his Kentucky teams the last 4 or 5 years have not been as good. But he had a stretch there when he went there in 2009 through about 2000, till about COVID almost, that he was dominating. He would dominate the conference tournament. His teams played good defense and very, very talented. The Harrison twins, Julius Randle, just you can go on and on. I could probably name 60 guys that played for him in that stretch of years. And he got the best. And when you saw great players in AAU basketball, Wes, when you were out recruiting and you saw a guy dominating more than all the great players, you're like, that kid's going to end up at Kentucky. And Coach Cal more than likely got it done.
When a coach is named at Arkansas, what do you expect to see happen with this team? Because this is a roster that needs to be completely rebuilt.
Right. Well, and I think it depends on who it is. If it is Coach, if he comes, obviously there's guys that were, you know, he had signed at Kentucky, and that'll be if it is him. There'll be some movement there, and then players on any coach that you hire. Now with the portal, there's a real good chance if he had success at his prior school that one or two or three of those guys might come as well. And then the new school, which in this case is us, you know, we've got guys in the portal that will be definitely marching to coach's office and trying to stay, and they will be trying to talk their way to stay as a Razorback. And then that's the decision for our new coach to – do I want this guy? Do I want that guy? And does he fit with who else I'm bringing in here? And then the third piece of building that roster will be the portal. And he has, you know, whoever it is, has to get in the portal and get us some players. So It's very important. I do think that there'll be a couple, two or three guys that are on our team, maybe even four, that will be back and that will play for whoever the new coach is. I've felt that ever since Coach Musk left. And so it'll be interesting. So a combination of that and the new coach maybe bringing in some of his own guys and then hitting the portal, that'll make this team up. And you can say we have zero guys or one guy or whatever you want to say right now, and just put a week on it, and within a week we will have several guys lined up for this team. This is a big-time place, and the new coach is going to have a whole lot of momentum when he gets here.
So you're saying there's no need to panic that when you look at the current roster and see no players?
No need at all, because it's early in April, and so much happens in the month of April. Now, if this was May the 9th, and we didn't have any guys, I'd be kind of a little bit worried, but it's April the 9th, and there is a whole lot of time, and a lot's going to happen. And if this was 7 years ago, I'd be in bad shape. I'd be worried to death. We wasn't going to win a game. But that's not the era. And I was, looking at all the kids listed on the portal last night, and after the national championship game, I was looking at all these guys, and there are so many good players, and many good players in our conference that are in the portal. And when you get a high-profile coach in here, hired in here, working, and if it does end up being who everyone thinks it's going to be, that he's going to be able to get most kids he wants. And so it changes Arkansas recruiting. Nothing against Coach Muss or Mike Anderson or Nolan Richardson or anybody, but Arkansas has probably never had this level of a guy that can get most any basketball player he wants.
Coach, what are your thoughts on Final Four that happened this weekend and championship game last night? UConn takes down Purdue.
Yeah.
Continue to be dominant.
Yeah, well, Coach Muss owes me $333 because I had to I always go to the Final Four for the National Association of Basketball Coaches. I was supposed to go Thursday, change the flight to Friday because I didn't want to leave Fayetteville. So instead of staying Thursday to Monday, I got there Friday, and then I came home Sunday because of everything going. I had to pay another change fee. And so with Musk leaving, I had to do a lot of flight changing. And I'm going to send that bill to Coach and see if he'll pay that for me. I doubt he will. But I did go up to Saturday. It was awesome being in Phoenix and seeing the games. I love going to the national semis. And really no surprise, the two teams that won to advance. I did think Purdue would hang in there, and I thought it would be a much closer game. I figured UConn would win. They were so good. Van Hurley, man, he has just got it going. Those kids are tough, and they make tough shots, and then they work the ball so well, and they're so patient, and that they get open shots. And Will Bartlett, who worked for Coach Anderson at St. John's, he told me, he said, man, when they get you down by 6 or 8 or 9 or 10 in the second half, it's almost over. They just run that clock, and then they run a great set right at the end, and then they'll score on you. It takes 30 seconds off the clock, and they've added 2 points. And that's what they did last night. They did it over and over, and that's what they did Saturday. And so it was good. A lot of people didn't think it was a good game. I was pretty entertained by it. Purdue just didn't have enough to beat UConn. And I tell you what, UConn, he's done a great job there to win back-to-back. That's very impressive. And Wes and Joe, before you let me go, that's why we got to keep the NCAA tournament as is or close to as is. And if we break away and people like the Big East just go away, we're not ever going to have a real national champion. They've won two in a row. And then you're going to say 5 years from now, 10 years from now, the Big East can't even participate in the tournament because all the big leagues moved. So I hope they hope the NCAA and the SEC and everybody just kind of leaves this NCAA tournament alone. I think it's awesome.
Matt Zimmerman with us on Out of Bounds. Coach, you mentioned your phone blowing up during the Final Four. What was it like there? Was there a kind of a buzz among all the coaches and all the people there about this possibility?
Yeah, and it was really all, I always wear Razorback gear pretty much everywhere I go. And so when I was at the Final Four on Friday roaming around, I was at the Sheridan downtown a lot. So that's where the head coach's hotel was. And the lobby of the head coach's hotel is always an incredible place. And everybody coming up to me and talking to me about the job. So it was like really every few minutes that someone would throw out a different name or, different things that were happening, or they hear this or they hear that. And then on Saturday, it was like Arkansas circling back to this guy, going back to that guy. So And I had talked to Hunter on Thursday after the coach had left on the phone. He was in Phoenix. I was in Fayetteville. I said, you need any help? You need anything? You need phone numbers? Of course, Hunter's got contacts to everyone. And he said, thanks, Z. I'll call you if I need you. I never heard from him again. So I knew he had everything. He was rolling. I wanted to offer that up. So when people would – I even had people say, call Hunter and ask him this, or please call Hunter and let him know. I'm not going to do that. After I'd called Hunter one time, I'm not going to bug him because he was very, very busy. But there was buzz all over the place. Everyone at the Final Four was talking about the Arkansas job. It was the biggest news, and everyone wanted to know who's going to get the Arkansas job, and they all wanted to talk about the rumors. And so it was – that part was pretty, pretty neat. And it was unusual because usually our staff's at the Final Four. Well, Coach Muss and Ruta and all them, they'd all gone out to California. So they didn't go to Phoenix, and we didn't have a staff hired. So there was really, like Todd, Coach Lee was out in Phoenix and his family, but the rest of the staff was not in Phoenix. So I felt like I was the only one from the school that was there after Hunter left.
What a week. What a weekend. It feels like a week.
Yeah.
It's only been a couple of days.
It's really long.
Yes.
You're right, Wes, because really it started, I know the rumors with Coach Musk happened like the Saturday and Sunday before that. That's when I first started hearing about it. But really it didn't heat up till about last Tuesday. And then Tuesday, Wednesday was all about Coach Musk. And then Thursday he says he's leaving for sure. It's out officially. And then, it was a whirlwind. We knew it would be a lot quicker than it was when they hired Coach Musk, which was about 12 days.
Mm-hmm.
And it ended up being really about three full days before we found out who it was. Hunter worked pretty fast.
Well, it's crazy to think. Eric Musselman left last week. It hasn't even been a week. It feels like two, 3 weeks ago that Musselman left.
Yeah. It really does, Wes. It seems like it, because of all the phone calls and texts, it does feel like it's been a long, long time. And I'm looking forward to seeing the new coach get here to Arkansas and their families and all the assistants that move in. And it's a new opportunity for somebody. It's new for the Razorbacks, and it's new for the new staff. It's a fun time. I am a little bit, I enjoyed being around Coach Musselman. It just ended up being 5 years. In some ways, it seems like he just got here. In other ways, it seemed like he was here for 15 years, But, Musk did some good things for sure and had those three good runs in the NCAA tournament. So,
are you part of the group picking up Coach at 6 tonight?
No, I wish I was, but they did not invite me. So,
I was just trying for another scoop, Coach.
Oh, man. No, I wish I was, but I've been in meetings at the Razorback Foundation all day, so when you text me to get on, I was very appreciative of you because I was able to slide out of the meeting. How about that?
You're welcome. So, yeah. You're welcome, buddy.
Anytime we can do that, Coach.
Hey,
absolutely.
What do you think?
I gotta go back in
there. Real quick, what do you think this means for the foundation? If this happens, yeah. I mean, this could be big.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. And we'll see whoever the coach is that gets here. A lot of times when you go through a coaching change, depending on who you hire, if you hire a young guy, it's better to be a major, you may not have to spend as much. If you hire a really high-profile coach, he's probably going to cost you more money than the previous coach did. Coach Musselman and his staff cost the Razorbacks a lot more than Mike Anderson and his crew did. And that's just how it goes. It happens with football that way. That's the nature of the business. So it'll be interesting as all the financials come out. And anytime you have a new coach for the Razorbacks, generally, there's a lot of excitement, and that's not against Coach Musselman at all. That's just what it is, and there will be excitement about a new coach and his people being here. So hopefully that does benefit the fundraising arm for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Hey, there's a lot going. You got the budget every year, and it's big, and that's what the Razorback Foundation does, help raise money for that budget. And then you got if we end up doing a capital campaign to Bud Walton, that's still being all figured out. And then name, image, and likeness, and that's a thing that's going every single year. It's not going away. That's three big deals. That is three big deals that require money to be successful.
Coach, you got to get to work.
Whew, man, you're not kidding. Some of those meetings had me scratching my head. I'm an old basketball coach, Wes. I'm like, my goodness. But it is a big deal, and the Razorbacks are a big deal. And, football, which right now is kind of being a little bit overshadowed, and, we got to have a great year in football. That's such a big part of the finances at Arkansas. And, so we really need big success this next school year from football and men's basketball big time.
Coach, thank you for your time. I appreciate you.
Okay, guys. We'll look forward to see who it is. I can't wait.
All right. Coach. See
you,
Coach.
Thank you.
It's John Calipari. Bye, Coach. Man, he's awesome. Always good to get Coach Z on here. There was a point I wanted to make, and I just forgot it. Oh, the Capitol campaign. This is a boost in the arm to the Capitol campaign. They, you know, they're trying to raise the funds. They're discussing the renovation of Bud Walton Arena, and it's needed. They can put in some new suites and luxury boxes or loge boxes. Just bring it to the year 2024 or when it's done, 2025, 2026. And after last season, the disappointment with Coach Musselman, it was going to be probably a little bit more difficult to raise that kind of money to get this renovation done. Now, they got to strike while the iron's hot. You bring this guy in, you better be hitting up people. Hey, we got to get this arena going. We got to be ready for Coach Cal and this team.
Oh, yeah.
I think that helps.
You want that to happen as soon as possible. Like, it's something that is long overdue, and now's the time to make it happen.
Awesome arena, but, yeah, it's 30 years old, you think about it. It needs a little facelift. It needs a little help. Age does that to people, you know, and structures. And that's all it needs, a little, but that's going to cost some big chunk of money, and that'll be the next thing that they're trying to do. And I know it's in discussions, and that's what when he said that, I was like, wow, well, this should help. The excitement around the program, this should help bring in some money to help with that capital improvement campaign.
Yeah, absolutely it will. The alternative is a new arena, but nobody wants that. You want to renovate. You want to bring up to date.
Yeah. That would be very costly. All right, we'll take a break. 2:30, yeah, it's wide open. We're going to draw some golfers for our Masters contest. And we'll take some phone calls. 661-1037. It's Out of Bounds.
Insure your auto, home, life, and everything in between with Shelter Insurance. Find a local agent by calling 1-800-SHELTER or at shelterinsurance.com.
This is SportsCenter.
In the midst of the John Calipari to Arkansas story, forward Trevin Bazile declared for the 2024 NBA draft yesterday. Brazil's time in Fayetteville has been marred with injury, playing in just 9 games last year and 26 games this year. He had a disappointing 2023-2024 campaign, averaging 9 points, 6 rebounds, and a block on 49% from the field and 35% from 3. He's considered by most outlets to be a late second-round pick at best. Shortly after his announcement, Arkansas commit Isaiah Elohim requested to be released from his national letter of intent. That leaves Arkansas with 0 scholarship players. And Arkansas baseball starts their 2-game home series against San Jose State tonight as first pitch is set for 6. Coverage can be heard on The Buzz starting at 5:30. I'm Christian Weaver with The Buzz Radio Network. Razorback pitcher Will McIntyre joins Morning Mayhem each week presented by Seth Boyd with Shelter Insurance. Give Seth a call for all your insurance needs at 501-982-6465.
Easy Cater. 100,000 restaurants, one platform. Need food for a meeting or a company event? Easy Cater has everything you need to make food for work, work. With easy online ordering and reordering. Save your favorite orders, make edits as needed, and click. We even help you with expenses by keeping your receipts all in one place, which means all you need to do is sit back and enjoy the food. From ordering to reporting, Easy Cater has everything to make food for work, work. Order 24/7 at easycater.com.
Again, Scent Bead story. Jim was at the laundromat when he heard, his ear said, Maraca, senor, but his nose said, hey, freshest scent ever. Following his nose, Jim found a man pouring a bottle of Gain Scent Beads into the washer. The scent, the freshness. Jim blurted, sir, your scent maracas smell amazing. Actually, Jim, most noses call them Gain Scent Beads. Try Gain Scent Beads, way fresher than detergent alone.
This is Pat Bradley for Brewskis. Everybody thinks about Brewskis for watching sports or having a great night out. But what about Brewskis for lunch? Both locations open at 11 a.m. 7 days a week with all your pub grub favorites, friendly service, kitchen all-stars are ready to serve you. Or, if you're not in a hurry, have a couple cold ones. Happy hour starts at 11 a.m. too. Brewskies, your home for lunch, happy hour, and late night now with two locations, downtown Little Rock and the brand new location in Lakewood Village, North Little Rock.
It's Justin Akers from my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Are you ready for a better forklift experience? River Valley Tractor and Castle Forklift have teamed up to manage your material handling needs. From diesel, lithium, propane, and so much more, Castle's product line is versatile, ready for the next generation of consumers to make every job easier. Step into the future of forklift innovation. Choose Castle. Visit River Valley Tractor, your authorized Castle forklift dealers in Central Arkansas.
Pickup truck, sports car, motorcycle, minivan, townhouse, two-story, farmhouse, fixer-upper. What you drive and where you live is different for everyone, so it's important to have insurance that fits your needs and is just right for you. At Shelter Insurance, we understand that. Which is why our agents help you design a comprehensive auto, home, and life insurance plan. Insurance that fits just right.
See shelter agent Matt Steele in Bryant, Todd Matthews in Benton, or Justin Stewart in Malvern today.
Maybe it's me, maybe I bore you.
Welcome back to Out of Bounds, Westmore Joe Franklin. Glad you're with us. Over on the text line, still not sponsored. You want it? You want to own it? The rights to it? Signal Media. Sales at Signal Media. They can get it done for you. Joe, you want it? The Joe Franklin text line? Mm. That would be cool.
Yeah. Don't need that much attention.
Would it help you? Could you profit off of it anyway?
Yeah. Yeah, we can find a way to make some money for sure.
Any information on the Coach Cal introduction press conference? I'm hearing tomorrow. I saw a tweet tomorrow night, 6 o'clock. I think it was Alyssa Orange, Pig Trail Nation. That's what she was hearing. We do not have anything official, I'll tell you that. Steve says, hey, Wes, when everything becomes official, how do you think this will affect Ronnie Jr.? And how do we enter the Masters contest? We're going to draw names for the Masters contest here soon.
There are people looking forward to it.
I think it's what Coach Cal just said, or Coach Cal.
Coach Z.
Matt Zimmerman, Coach Z, just said, yeah, it'd be part of the process. That you would think Ronnie would go in there and try to get an interview, and or probably would get an interview and see if it would be a good fit. It's just how the process goes. There were a couple comments about Coach Z. JK said it best. Coach Z never said who is going to be the next head coach. He's a true professional.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. He is.
And Coach Z has to be careful because he works for the university, the foundation, and and I did not want to put him in a bad spot. And that's why I always said, if it happens, we know it's going to happen. But I just had to throw the hypothetical out there for Coach to talk about.
Robbie Avila from Indiana State is in the transfer portal.
That's the Larry Bird kid? Larry Nerd? Isn't that what they call him, Larry
well,
Nerd?
They have all kinds of names for him. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Milk Chamberlain, like all kinds of things. But yeah, he's in the portal.
Yeah,
now.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. I've heard that one. That's a good one. All right, that's cool. He's made a name for himself, that's for sure. Let's go to Steve. He is in Morrilton. Steve, welcome into Out of Bounds. What's up?
Wanting to draw for the golfer.
Oh, you want to get going? They want to get going on this thing?
Yeah, there's excitement about it.
All right. Well, I didn't know we were going to do that right now, but I'm a nice guy, Steve. So I cut up. All right, let me explain to everybody. I took the Masters field. I cut up a ton of names. There's 89 guys in the Masters this year. And I took the names, the guys that we probably know and you'll probably know. Cut them up in a piece of paper. I got them here in a cup, and I'm going to draw a golfer. That's your golfer. If your golfer wins, you're going to win the driver and a driver fitting, thanks to our friends at Arkansas Golf Center there in Conway. So that's the competition.
All right.
And there is also a piece of paper in here that's called the field. And I've got I bet it's 30 golfers that are in the field. And I'll be honest with you, it's a lot of no-name golfers. It's a lot of amateurs. But I threw in a couple of decent golfers in there just to give you a chance. But you've got, if you draw the field, you still got a chance. Your golfer,
okay.
The first golfer, Steve. And you know what, Steve?
Yes.
Got to a bad start.
I dropped my pen. Steve, I'm going to have your last name because there are a bunch of Steves out there. So I got to know in case you win and you got a chance to win. What's your last name?
Wofford.
Gotcha. Steve, you have Jason Day.
All right.
Thank you. From now on, will you when you get their information and type it on the board, type in their last name, and I'll just write it in. That way, there's no confusion whenever Jason Day happens to win. Ryan's in Hot Springs. What's up, Ryan?
Oh, hey, give me just a second. I'm trying to bass fish a little bit while I was waiting to call.
How's the fishing today?
I know, right? Yeah, well, I'm trying to catch. I've already caught one. I'm just trying to get out here in between the rains before this next set of rain comes in. But the reason why I called was when I say this, I'm not trying to sound like I'm out on the Cal Hire. I don't hear any apprehension. Is it really? I mean, with his track record the last couple of days or couple of years, is anybody y'all not really nervous about him? Maybe not having the success that he previously had with his age and kind of how things have gone. I hope it's not a Jimbo Fisher situation, but I've heard that put out there, and mm-hmm. I was just curious y'all's thoughts. And like I said, I'm kind of the wait and see kind of situation, and I'm gonna enjoy the ride while it's here. But just thought I'd get y'all's thoughts on that. And if y'all handing out golfers, I'll take one too if you don't mind.
Okay, I'll draw you one. Ryan, you have Ryan, Kurt Kitayama. Who? What's your last name, Ryan?
Wilhite, Wilhite.
Okay. Good deal. You got it.
I hope y'all have a. Yes, sir. I hope y'all have a great day, and I'll be listening while I'm doing some fishing.
All right, good luck to you, Ryan. Thanks. Apprehension, look, the record speaks for itself. It hasn't been great, and especially not for the Kentucky standards. If he comes to Arkansas and goes to tournament after tournament after tournament and loses in the first round or the second round, after a while, that's going to get old. The expectations at Kentucky is for a Final Four. Are the expectations at Arkansas the Final Four? And heck, maybe the expectations in Kentucky is winning the whole thing. I don't think right now the expectations at Arkansas is the Final Four winning at all. Right now, I'm wanting to, for this year, I don't have any expectations right now for this year because he doesn't even have a team. But yeah, in the back of my mind, you can't just dismiss the fact that the last couple of years haven't been good and they haven't been as good for Calipari than the first 6 years. The first 10 were good at Kentucky. The last five, not bad. Let's don't mix that up. They weren't bad, They just weren't as good as the first 10 years. But the standard at Kentucky is higher. I'm a little worried about that. But I've kind of said it here before. I think this is a different Calipari that's coming in. I think he's going to be motivated. I think he wants to prove people wrong. I think he wants the new challenge. And I also know he is very excited about coaching with his son. And I think that's going to help him also, kind of rejuvenate him, get the blood going again.
I'm not sure he needed to be motivated in any kind of way because he's one of those coaches that he's trying to get top talent, and the goal is to get these players to the NBA. So it's just the results haven't been there the past few years. As mentioned, you know, the first 6 years, they were a lot more successful than the last 9 years, and especially these last 4 years, when you're talking about either losing the first game of the NCAA tournament or making it to the second game and losing that. So that's what it's been over the past 4 years or so.
2-4 in the last 4 years in the tournament?
Yeah.
2 wins, 4 losses. Let's go to Jason. Jason's in Little Rock. What's up, Jason? Shoot. I hung up on Jason. Wrong button. My bad. Yeah. Call back, Jason. My bad. Jeff. What's up, Jeff?
Hey, what's up, Wes? Hey, has anybody checked on Stan? I hadn't heard from Stan. Is he all right?
Who?
Stan.
We have not heard from Stan. I have no idea.
Somebody needs to call and check on Stan. I'm worried about it.
We called him out yesterday, and he never dialed in to see how he was doing.
Hey, congratulations on the breaking news, Wes. Give me my golf pick.
You have the field, Jeff.
All right.
If you really want to know who all you have, email me at the TV station WMoore@Fox16, and I'll get up there, I'll look at all the golfers and I'll send you the whole list of the field just so you have a rooting interest.
Thank you. Hey, great show. Y'all are awesome. Appreciate it. Have a good day.
Later, Jeff.
Thank you.
I gotta get better on hanging up on people. That's ridiculous. I'm mad at myself for hanging up. James joins us now. James, what's up? Welcome to Out of Bounds.
What's up, man? I was just trying to get in on the podcast and get a golfer.
James, I got your golfer, and it is Tiger Woods. How do you feel about that?
Man, I'll take it. I know it's a long shot, but, man, hey, like everybody else, I've always been a Tiger fan, so I'll take it.
Yesterday it was Will Zalatoris from Simmons Bank. Well, Simmons Bank, he represents.
Right.
He played with Tiger, and he said that's the best I've seen Tiger hit it. Ever.
Ever. What?
But, you know, Will's young, and he didn't play with the dominant Tiger Woods of old, so he just knows the Tiger of, you know, years past. But, yeah, he said he was striping it.
He's going to get everybody excited.
I know. He got me excited.
But with Tiger walking, I mean, that's going to be his biggest feat to overcome.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah.
Because of the 30.
4 days of it. Hopefully 4 days of it. James, thanks.
Sure.
Good luck.
Thank y'all.
Yep. Let's go to Sam. Sam, I am. What's up, man?
Wes, what's up, buddy? How you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm good. Hey, I want to enter the Masters competition.
I got you. You have Victor Hovland.
All right, I like it. I like that bit.
All right, I got you down. Good luck.
All right, thanks, guys. You bet. Bye.
Bye. James is up next. Oh, no, Jason. Jason, welcome to Out of Bounds.
Hey, guys. Just calling to get a golfer.
Okay. Jason, I got you Xander Schauffele.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
All right. Good luck. Simple. Except for I hung up on him before guy's last name. God, I suck. Chris. What's up, Chris?
Hey, guys. How are y'all?
Good.
Good. Sitting in the car line, waiting to pick up a kiddo, and I'd love to get a golfer.
Is it raining?
Nope, not right now.
Good. Chris, you have Matt Fitzpatrick.
Hey, I'll take that one.
Yeah, you will. I bet you will. Thanks. Go to Tim. Tim, you're up next. You want a golfer?
Hey, guys, how's it going? Yeah, I do.
Camellia Vichiegas.
I'll take him.
Okay. All right, good luck.
Hey, we'll take him. Hey, hold on. I got a question for you. Hey, so Trey said he kind of beat you to the punch. He put it on his website, but it was more, he didn't say that. He said it was a possibility. Kind of put it out there as a joke. I said, that's pretty good, Trey. Kind of rain on life parade. Another thing, Cal is going to be Cal. He's a good recruiter. He's definitely going to have to get a little age on him because the guys he's recruiting are high school, and they're playing against men now. It's pretty much a semi-pro ball right now. So he's going to have to mix that up with some guys out of the portal that's got a little age on him. So he'll be fine. I mean, this is the best thing that Arkansas has done.
Yeah.
And but, you know, somebody said, hey, what other coach have we hired that had that kind of name? Bobby Petrino came out of the pros when we got him, and that was a kind of a shock to do
yeah.
Overnight. So, all right, you guys have a good one.
Thanks, man. Take care.
What Cal does have is a reputation for putting players in the NBA. Mm-hmm. Rob Dillingham on NBA Today right now.
Yeah.
And declaring for the draft.
Yeah. That was one of the reasons he couldn't have a players-only meeting, because so many of the current players were declaring for the draft. They were off training, getting ready for the camp. And so there wasn't any players there to talk to. Scratch him off the list coming to Arkansas. He wasn't on the list.
We knew where he was going anyway.
Yeah, we knew that. All right, we got to take a break. We'll draw some more names when we come back, and we'll draw some names in the third hour. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
The Can-Am sales event going on now at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Check out Spyder and Riker motorcycles, Can-Am ATVs, and Sea-Doo personal watercraft, all with special financing. Save thousands on all remaining 2023 Can-Am models today at all Bradford Marine and ATV locations.
Always ride responsibly and safely. Follow all product instructional and safety materials. Observe all applicable laws and regulations for your safety. Always wear appropriate protective gear and clothing. Please remember that riding and alcohol or drugs don't mix. For ATV drivers, it's highly recommended to take a training course. For ATV safety and training information, see your dealer or call the ATV Safety Institute at 1-800-887-2887.
Heartland Rehabilitation and Care Center in Benton proudly offers compassionate and loving care to our veterans, meeting the unique needs of every veteran who calls Heartland home. Visit heartlandrehabcenter.com.
One in six black men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer in his lifetime, and we're more than twice as likely to die from the disease. Plus, a family history of prostate cancer can double your risk. We can do something about this. We can take control of our health, and that starts with talking to your doctor about getting screened for prostate cancer with a simple blood test, because it's your life, and when prostate cancer is caught early, it's highly treatable. If you want more info, the Prostate Cancer Foundation is here to help. Go to pcf.org/knowyourrisk today.
Drivers who switch and save with Progressive could save hundreds, which could be life-changing. I mean, you could put that money towards that zero-turn lawnmower you've always wanted. And after using its edge-shaping technology to meticulously sculpt the face of the Mona Lisa into your grass, you'll become the undisputed king of Saturday morning lawn care, leaving your neighbor and sworn enemy Gary to question his place in the delicate neighborhood ecosystem. And it's all because you could save money switching at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Not available in all states.
Get the one and done you want for your dog's monthly protection. NexGard Plus, a Fox Alarm, Moxidectin, and Pyrantel chewable tablets. Protects against fleas, ticks, heartworm disease, roundworms, and hookworms. All in one delicious, beef-flavored soft chew. Use with caution in dogs with a history of seizures or neurologic disorders. Dogs should be tested for existing heartworm infection prior to starting a preventive. Ask your vet about NexGard Plus Chews.
I'm Rick Pennington of Lions Drug. We have great news. Generic Cialis is now available at a huge savings. We have Tadalafil, the FDA-approved generic of Cialis, in a 20-milligram tablet at a savings of up to 80%. We have the 5-milligram daily tablets for less than $3 a pill. Lions Drug continues to be your go-to pharmacy for men's health. What are you waiting for? Call us today at 844-676-2247. Or go to our website at lionsdrug.com.
Hey there, you in aisle two. I see you by the fiber and laxatives. You still using those to manage your constipation with belly pain? If your symptoms keep coming back, you may have irritable bowel syndrome with constipation, or IBS-C. So you may need more than over-the-counter treatments to manage it. Ask your doctor about how Linzess can help you get ahead of it.
Linzess linaclotide is a prescription medicine that treats IBS-C in adults. It's not a laxative. It's a once-daily pill that helps you get ahead of your symptoms. It's proven to help you have more frequent and complete bowel movements and helps relieve overall abdominal symptoms, belly pain, discomfort, and bloating. These symptoms were studied in combination, not individually. Do not give Linzess to children less than 2. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stools. The most common side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas, stomach area pain, and swelling. Learn more at Linzess.com or call 1-800-LINZESS.
Tune in each week on Morning Mayhem as Bo Mattingly joins the guys and gives his behind-the-scenes look that he gets from his relationship with the University of Arkansas. Thanks to UAMS Health, the official orthopedics and sports medicine provider for Razorback Athletics.
Glad you're with us. Fun day. Coach Z was awesome. Dusty Hanna starting us off. Hear from Coach Calipari addressing Big Blue Nation. Got him on his way to Fayetteville. Press conference tomorrow, it sounds like. Tomorrow night, apparently. Got to figure that out. May have to do the show up there tomorrow, Joe.
For the press
conference. Yeah, they may. TV may want me up there. I don't know. I'll let you know. We'll figure it out. Let's draw a couple of names before we hit the top of the hour break. We got about 2 minutes. We'll keep this really quick. Let's run through these names. Brett's up first. You want a golfer?
Yes, sir.
All right, Brett, you have Ricky Fowler. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
No? Okay.
He doesn't sound excited about Ricky
Fowler. You may give that to somebody else?
At all.
Nah, I'll keep him. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine.
All right, later, Brett.
Brett said, what has he won?
Not the Masters. Justin, welcome into Out of Bounds.
Hey, Wes, how you doing?
I'm good. You want a golfer?
Yes, please.
Carl Schwartzel.
I'll take it.
All right, I got you down. Thanks, Justin. It wasn't Acree. One more. Where are we? Yeah, we got Jimmy. Jimmy, welcome into Out of Bounds. Oh.
Hey, guys.
Huh.
Give me a golfer.
All right. I want to hear your reaction to this one. I think I'm going to put a little futures bet on this guy. I think he's got a shot this year. Rory McIlroy.
All right. All right. Hey, I'm looking forward to Kentucky swinging and missing on a few big hires here, too.
Mm-hmm.
I love to see them be disappointed. That'll be great. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Jimmy. So, they're going to try Hurley. I think they can throw all the money they want to at Hurley. I think Hurley's going to stay at UConn. They're going to try Drew at Baylor. That, I don't know. I mean, does he want to move his family and do all that? I don't know. But they're going to try. Maybe they swing and miss. The name that I heard, Billy Donovan. I think it makes sense. Donovan wants a job this time. I know he's turned them down a couple of times. I've been told. And look, I'm not playing insider game. That's just a name to watch. I told my Kentucky guys last night on the podcast about that, and they're like, okay. Third time's a charm, maybe. I'm just throwing that one out there. All right. See, Steve, Jimmy, you're going to stay on hold. It's top of the hour break. When we come back, I'll draw you a golfer. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritunes, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
Clint Sterner here. Guys, if you've noticed a lack of energy, motivation, and drive, it could be low T. Be sure to schedule your health assessment at Low T Center. For established patients, they offer the convenience of physician-monitored self-inject at-home testosterone treatments with an average payment of $150 a month cash pay, including labs and medication. If you need the convenience of at-home treatment, Low T Center makes it easy, shipping treatments directly to your house. Go to lowtcenter.com now to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at alcoacommunityfcu.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties.
I'm so angry.
Don't be upset. You can always listen to us.
You're better than that.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Funeral arrangements are still being made for Shorter College president Jerome Green. Green died on Monday. He was 69 years old. Green was appointed the 45th president of Shorter College in 2012. He earned his doctorate at the University of Arkansas at Little Rock in the School of Law. In addition to acquiring a bachelor's at Miles College, he would work there and the Arkansas Ethics Commission before becoming president at Shorter College. We'll keep you updated as soon as we know more. In Russellville, love was in the air during during the eclipse as couples from 22 different states got married all at the same time. The ceremony happened just before the solar eclipse reached totality across Arkansas, giving the couples a chance to experience that as husband and wife. We spoke with one couple who says they've been together for several years, and when they saw this chance arise, they said, why not, and signed up to elope. The ceremony lasted 13 minutes and was officiated by one person who married all of the couples just before the solar eclipse entered totality. From the Channel 7 newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Rain and thunderstorms likely today, a little bit cooler too, with a high of just 67 degrees. More rounds of rain expected Wednesday and early Thursday. A few strong storms possible, but definitely some heavy rain. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse presents Match Game on Morning Mayhem. Listen for your chance to play their version of the classic TV game show. Brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters for over 30 years. Call 501-568-0040 today or click online at arkansastruck.com.
This is Pat Bradley for Brewskis. UFC 300, Saturday, April 13th. Arkansas's very own Bryce Thug Nasty Mitchell will be in the building at Brewski's downtown. Get there early Saturday night and meet the legend himself. Main event features light heavyweight brawl between Alex Pereira and Jamal Hill. And the undercard is loaded. UFC 300, Saturday, April 13th at 9 p.m. Both locations, downtown and north. Meet Bryce Thug Nasty Mitchell in the building at Brewski's downtown. And stick around because the party doesn't stop until 2 a.m. Brewski's, you home for lunch, happy hour, and late night.
Love off-roading? There's a 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss at Guatney Chevrolet ready for a driver. It's got improved shocks and suspension, plus wheels made for the off-road. You can make it yours for as low as $61,905. Call, click, or come visit Guatney Chevrolet to hear about our available rebates, and we'll make you the boss of the trail. Come see us in Jacksonville or visit GuatneyChevrolet.com. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Brakes? We can save you 15% on that. We have OE quality Duralast brake pads and rotors in stock, ready for pickup or delivery. We also have calipers, brake fluid, tools, and anything else you'll need to do the job right. When you get Duralast pads and rotors together, you'll save 15%. It's just part of what makes us America's number one brakes destination.
It's Justin Akre for Serta Pro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get Serta Pro Painters on the case today. SertaPro.com, that's Serta with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right because they take pride in what they do. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Greatness doesn't happen overnight. It takes time, focus, and dedication. At Shelter Insurance, we understand that because we put in the hard work and dedication for decades. And that commitment has paid off with award-winning customer service for your auto, home, and life insurance.
See shelter agent Paul Killingsworth in Cabot, Jonathan Stone in Lone Oak, or Steven Reeser in Jacksonville today.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. and the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Live from the Signal Media Studios, this is Out of Bounds with Joe Franklin and Wes Moore on 103.7 The Buzz.
Hour number 3. What's up, everybody? Glad you're with us. Wes Moore, Joe Franklin, Trey Schaap hanging out with us. He heard Masters talk and golfers and ran down the hall and was like, I want in. You want your mic on too? Is that helps? There you go.
That's up to you. You run the board, so.
I'm still figuring things
out,
Trey.
I like
Trey.
That Yeti you have over there. Man.
Oh, yeah, the cowboy.
Yeah.
You know who gave me that?
Who?
Acree. It was
really?
My Christmas gift, yeah. He gave me the Yeti, the Cowboys Yeti. And,
okay.
There's a, not a spatula, but a, flip your meat on the barbecue.
That's like a, yeah.
What are you looking at, Joe?
It's a spatula.
Your steaks, not your meat. Your steaks and your spatula.
Right.
No, but what's the fancy meat. Name for your grill? The,
yeah.
What am I thinking about?
It's a spatula, isn't it?
Oh, there's something else.
Is it metal?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's.
That's the word I'm thinking. Joe, quit laughing about, I said flip my meat. And what do you use? Not the tongs. It's like a special, I think, of using
it's
in the frying,
spatula,
frying pan with your eggs and, your little bacon or whatever, your sausage, you use a little spatula there.
Right,
But when you're on the grill, that's not a spatula, is it?
Yeah.
It is?
It's just a metal one.
Okay.
He's got to flip his meat, Joe.
I don't want it to burn.
No, you don't want your meat to burn.
I burnt the bacon Saturday. I was such a failure.
How does that happen?
So I put Acree's got me cooking my bacon in the oven and put it in there like at 450 for like 20 minutes. But our convection oven cooks great, so you can't go 20 minutes. Well, I was in a hurry and I thought, all right, I'm going to go ahead and put it in now before it preheated. And I was like, so it'll probably go about 20 minutes.
Right.
And so I sat down and I started getting on Twitter and doing this and going through my emails. The next thing, ding, and I'm like, oh, God, the bacon. And I ran over there and it was
cooked great in the microwave.
Oh, man.
Air fryer. Maybe
air fryer. Air fryers are the best.
I got to do that.
You can cook anything in there.
Yes.
So we started. I wasn't going to start the Masters contest the last segment, and people heard Masters contest and started calling.
Hey.
And I was like, well, kind of forced my hand, so here we go. So we started drawing. During the breaks, I've been drawing for people over on the text line.
Yeah.
Look,
are you going to run out of names before we get to Wednesday?
So there's 89 guys.
Right.
And I bet I did the field with about 30 golfers. I took a bunch of no-names,
so
amateurs. And I threw a couple of nice golfers in there. But there's probably 50 golfers that we're going to draw.
Can I draw one for me?
No, I'm joking.
I
you can draw
can't.
One.
Yeah, draw one for somebody.
You can draw one for Steve.
Yeah, draw one,
I
Trey.
Bet Steve wants a golfer. You want a golfer, Steve?
Hey, if it's Trey Schaap approved, I'll take him.
I like this one, and I like his chances, too.
Uh-oh.
Will Zalatoris.
Oh, nice.
Hey, I'll take that all day.
Simmons
I'll
Bank.
I'll take that all day.
Yeah.
I've got one quick question, guys, before I drop off. Y'all think Coach Cal will ever be able to find his way to Bank OZK Arena, unlike Must?
Ooh, good question.
But
it depends on
J.J.
Andrews
is playing there or Tarion Burgess is playing there.
But it also depends on the SEC tournament because,
not this year.
I'm not sure about next year, but it depends on when their schedule is and who's playing and when, yeah.
Yeah, I was disappointed. Maybe some, I'm busy calling the games and maybe I missed somebody, but I was disappointed I didn't see some coaches there for men or women because of the quality of the players that we had.
Right.
J.J. was there. Tarion Burgess was there. And then on the women's side, there was a sophomore, I can't think of her name now, from Farmington?
I believe so. I know that
she's offered from Arkansas, and she's good.
I know that Steve Weedor, assistant basketball coach for Little Rock, was there on Saturday. Mm-hmm. Of course, we got back late. They got back late Friday night after losing the first round, but the OVC tournament happened the same time last year as that.
That effort matters. Yep. Jimmy joins us now. Jimmy, what's up? You want a golfer?
Yeah, and I got a quick question.
All right, what's your question?
Well, first off, I mean, with Beard getting a raise out of this deal and you know, their athletic director being from Arkansas, he made kind of a snooty, cocky post on Twitter about going, you know, turkey hunting and having a beard. And he's like, I'm telling y'all, the Ole Miss is not here to play around or something like that. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw it.
Last Friday. But I'm just curious, do you think we went hard after Beard before approaching Cal?
Yes. I think Hunter tried to wrap him up, and when I mean wrap him up, keep him at Arkansas for 4 or 5 years so that he couldn't leave. And I think that was a sticking point, and I think that held up the negotiations. I don't know if it was the final straw. We'll have to ask Chris Beard that one day, but I think that was an issue.
Okay. Well, I was like you. I was really disappointed all weekend when you broke that news. It was awesome.
You made you feel better?
Trey, you can take credit if you want to.
No. Wes had it first. We were
all
talking.
Right. We talked throughout the day.
We talked quite a bit on Sunday back and forth. I was having lunch when I got the phone call and stepped out, and my wife's like, I hate coaching searches.
Jimmy, I think I just hung up on Jimmy and didn't ever tell him his golfer, but he's okay. Listening. You got John Rahm.
Oh, wow. Nice. Defending champion.
Yeah. I got your name down, Jimmy. You got John Rahm.
And the Masters, the champion's dinner tonight with Mr. Rahm.
What's he serving?
I forgot what it is. It's a flair of Spanish, a Spanish flair to the champion's dinner.
Isn't that funny how it works, though, to Jimmy's point? You have a coach that you're after, and you want him to leave a school after one season, but then you tell him, you can't leave us the same way.
Yeah. Right.
That's how negotiations go.
Yeah. Well, if I'm Hunter, I don't have to turn around next year or 2 years later and hire another coach. I want to keep this guy for the next 4 or 5 years.
I don't know if I told you this, Wes, on Sunday or not, but I texted an AD in the league and said, are you going to be able to keep your coach away from Kentucky? And he goes, is it happening? And I said, yeah, it's happening. He goes, we can't compete with Kentucky money.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Not many people can. I mean, they're going to throw a ton of money at Hurley.
Yep.
UConn's going to be able to give him a raise. He's going to have to decide, do I want to give up a little money to go to Kentucky, or do I want to stay here at UConn and what I've built? I think he stays, honestly.
I think he does, too. And I don't know if the talk of his wife not wanting to leave – you know, that area of the country, Connecticut, mm-hmm. and move to Lexington. I don't know if that's his way of saying, hey, putting it all on her. But
it's a good way out, though.
It could be.
Coming off the back-to-back championship, though, yeah, how do you make that leave. Move?
Yeah, I agree with you, freak.
All right, Brian, let's get you a golfer. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, you have Cameron Smith.
That's not bad.
All right, that'll work. Thank you.
Live golfer, you back to back. You pulled back to back live golfers out of there.
Well, there's quite a call. What can I say? That's PGA needs to talk about that. Cameron Smith, Brian, gotcha. John's up next. John, welcome into Out of Bounds. What's up?
Hey, good afternoon, guys.
I'm guessing you want a golfer.
If that's possible, yes. And then I'd like to know a little bit more. Information about Coach Cal. What's the big? What are we going to do? Are we going to win a national title finally? Or
those are lofty goals, but that's
gonna
the
have
goal.
You're going to have great talent on the court, especially with that NIL pool. There should be great talent on the court.
Yes, and then like y'all were talking about earlier about getting Bud Walton done, that'd be great to have something to advertise that big to get some better recruits in.
But here's the thing, too, with Bud Walton. You're going to have to not be in it for the non-conference of a full – one of your seasons, your non-conference games are not going to be in Bud Walton Arena. You almost wish that that would have been done before you get this new coach. And unfortunately, it's just not going to work out that way.
Right, right. Yep. Well, let's hope we can get an SEC title out of this at least.
I think they – that may be a tournament title too. I mean, yeah.
You got Adam Hadwin.
All right. Awesome. Thank you, guys.
You bet.
I mean, I think it's going to be a good Masters tournament this year.
No doubt. I started looking at some of the futures and guys. I'm like, ooh, I want him, him. And I'm like, I can't pick that many.
I know.
You know, at some point your return, is even if you do win, is not as great.
No.
So I'm trying to limit it, and it's
I mean,
it's
like
hard.
Scottie Scheffler. I mean, I think he's – I mean, he's probably playing the best of anybody right now. But, I mean, what, 4-1 on Betts Harrison?
Yeah.
Man.
Still, four times your money is still pretty
it
good.
It is.
But it's not like some of these others are 15-1.
Or 20-1.
Yeah.
That you would think might have a chance.
So Scheffler is your top choice right now?
That's the betting
choice. I don't see how you can't go against him the way he's been playing. What, he won Bay Hill and TPC back-to-back?
Yeah.
How do you not go
take
with
four golfers, make him one of your four, and if he wins, you at least you don't lose anything.
Right.
And then you've got three kind of longer shots.
And here's the other thing, too, guys. We hear this all the time. Tiger's striping it. Tiger's hitting it so good. He wants to play well at Augusta.
Did you see Will's quote?
Yes.
What was his quote, the best he's ever seen him
play? Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
And then he played with Fred and Justin Thomas today, and Freddie Couples said, hey, look, he's not here just to compete this time. He's the way he's hitting it, he's here to try and win this thing. That tells me that Tiger making the cut could be a reality this year.
Yeah. Chad joins us now. Chad, what's up? Welcome to Out of Bounds.
Man, I'm hoping to get Tiger withdrawn in this golf tournament.
Yeah, he's already gone, isn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
He was one maybe the second or third golfer.
Yeah, it was early.
I think you'll be happy. Yeah. He's a local guy, Taylor Moore.
Yeah, there you go. From a Razorback.
Yeah. I say local, but I think I call him local. He's one of us. Let's go to Jeff. Jeff, welcome in. What's up?
Hey, guys. Hey, thanks for taking my call. I got a question, and I'd like a golfer if I could. I was told the fans will get behind this coach and if he comes and, support him and not browbeat him with a bunch of questions and it's stuff against him. Give him time to do his thing and let's support this guy. We haven't had a coach like this, so I'm really excited about it. That's all I got.
All right, Jeff, you've got you got a champion, Phil Mickelson.
All right. Cool. I like it.
There you go.
Another live golfer.
A lefty live golfer.
You think Phil has a shot?
No.
And not shot, a legitimate shot. Everybody's got a shot.
Everybody that tees up has a shot. Yeah. I mean, it could go right for 72 holes, but no.
Okay. Angry Buckeye, what's up, man?
What's up, fellas? I'm going to get a golfer here.
Okay. I got you Keegan Bradley.
Nah, let's try again.
I mean, I can hang up on you and throw the name back in the pot.
Nah, I'm messing with you. At least I got a horse in the race.
Yeah,
we'll
you do. All right, later. Good luck trying to get back in.
Hey, I just got this sent to me.
Check that out.
It's cool. Cal in red.
That's all you need to say.
Oh.
Not where it is or anything like that, but
right
now that's all we can say.
Oh, I see where it is now. Okay.
Yeah.
Honestly, it looked like a graphic from the Pig Trail Nation.
Yeah, it's not
in
a
their
graphic.
Studio.
Yeah.
No.
No,
that's cool. He looks weird in red. We're going to have to get used to that.
I was wondering, all right, I was talking in the office with Dustin. You've seen him wear some blue jackets when he would play like Tennessee, when Kentucky would play Tennessee and stuff.
Blue shirts underneath.
Not knowing what the schedule is for next year yet, but if Arkansas does play in Rupp, and obviously when Kentucky comes to Fayetteville, if they do next year, does he go with a cardinal jacket with a white shirt with, like, red buttons? for that.
We can say the day of wearing polos.
He's not going to wear a polo to coach a game.
No, he's going to be in a suit.
Yeah.
And he's going to have red suits that he wears at time.
I don't know if
he wears a red suit every time like he would do at Kentucky.
No, but I think I think when they play Kentucky, I think that's what he wears.
Okay. Just limited to that. Maybe, you know, coaches are going jumpsuit.
That or Texas. I mean, hey, think about this. Texas is a conference game next year now.
Yeah.
We do not have the basketball opponent, or do we have the basketball opponents?
I don't think we even have that for next year.
We know who the permanent opponents are? No, we don't.
No.
That's Coach Z was saying he hopes we can keep the same basketball opponents that we have now because it's
LSU. Well, one of them is
going to
be Missouri, you would think. Yeah. But, yeah. Mm.
Let's go to Big John. Big John, you want a golfer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, you have Adam Scott.
Okay. That's a decent player there. We have a chance.
He's a past champion.
Yes, sir.
Thanks, Big John. What do you think of Adam Scott, Trey?
It used to be Trey's guy.
Yeah, I liked Adam Scott.
Yeah.
I still like Adam Scott, the Aussie. He had a Tiger's old caddy, Steve, on the bag. So
He hasn't played really good in a while.
He really hadn't. He won in a playoff the year he won, but I like his game quite a bit.
He's still capable.
Yeah.
Ryan's up next. Ryan, what's up?
I need a driver that works with. Give me a good one.
Okay. This is a good one. We'll get Trey's thoughts on Wyndham Clark.
Yes.
I like it.
That's a good one.
I like it. I'll take it. Yep. Thank you, Wes. What you doing, Freaky Joe?
What's up, Ryan?
What's going on, buddy? Good show, man. Love it.
Hey, appreciate it.
Thanks, Ryan. Jason is in Conway. Jason, what's up?
Hey, guys. I just had a quick question about the NCAA tournament. Would the viewership have been down this year because it was on TBS and not on the local channels?
Could be.
Secondly, my next question is has anybody checked on Stan since we didn't hire Noah Richardson? I mean, is he going to be okay?
Stan has not called in. I don't know. We threw a shout out yesterday. We've done it today. Now, granted, it is hard to get in right now with everybody calling in. I've got people on the text line saying I've been trying and trying and trying, and I can't get in. But, we got to put a call out for Stan and see if he's okay with Cal Perry.
But like I was saying about the TBS thing, like I didn't even watch the game last night because it was on that and HBO Max, of which I don't have. I have Amazon Prime, so, yeah, I see the NFL game. But I know it's all about the dollars. But wondering why they don't put – the NCAA tournament, and they're real proud of it, trying to keep it. Why they're not putting it on local channels, I guess it is about the almighty dollar.
Yeah,
so. But thanks, guys, for letting me call. I appreciate it.
Yeah,
there was something in that agreement, Wes, mm-hmm. when they made that agreement with CBS and Turner, TBS.
Because Turner forked over a lot of money, and they didn't want to just be doing first and second round games. They wanted to get the big dog at one point.
What is it, every 4 years, I think they get the final four, basically.
Yeah, it's a rotation, and they're throwing them a bone. That's it. They put a lot of money in this TV contract, and so I understand it. I mean, if you're going to pony up that much money, you need to be able to have the big game from time to time.
Right.
I streamed it.
I tell you what, though. I liked when Jim Nance did it, but I think Ian Eagle is great.
Not once last night did I ever think about Jim Nance.
I know.
I didn't think about it until you just brought it up.
And I like Raftery. Joe, you know that.
Mm-hmm.
Big-time Raftery fan. And I think even Grant Hill, you know, he adds so much to the broadcast. But those three, I thought, did an excellent job with the Final Four this year.
Absolutely.
And their basketball coverage in general.
Jim Nance, his presence is still felt because he does the Capital One commercials with Charles Barkley and the crew there. So they featured him throughout, but, you know, he had the send-off last year, and it was the perfect way to do it, to end where it all began. He's from Houston, and they ended in Houston, so that was cool.
And then also, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but they showed Gene Cady, and they were talking about the P that he had in the back of his head.
Mm-hmm.
And Ian Eagle said, you know, Raftery's got a big R in the back of his, and Raftery, without missing a beat, said, "Well, you got a dollar sign in the back of yours." Oh, I mean, it's nice. Just, oh, it was so great and classic that, and then, of course, Bill Raftery goes straight into talking about the defense that was being played so that, you know, Ian didn't have a chance. And his name being Ian Eagle, he always kept calling him Bird and stuff throughout some of the broadcasts. So, yeah, I just, little things like that I like.
Charlie's up next. Charlie, welcome on to Out of Bounds. You want a golfer?
I do.
Colin Morikawa.
All righty.
Thanks, Charlie. I think that's a good one.
Absolutely.
Morikawa's got a chance to win, doesn't he, Trey? Good chance.
I think so. Yeah. I mean, look, almost anybody that tees it up there is going to have a chance. There are some that don't. Fred Couples doesn't have a chance to win. But there are most of them. I would say about 50 to 55 of them that tee it up have a chance to win. Maybe even more than that.
Cole is up next. Cole, what's up?
Wes, you got to give me a good golfer. Come on, man.
Well, Cole, I'm writing your name down. You think Cole will be happy with that?
Cole, if you don't want him, I'll take him.
Who is it?
Scottie Scheffler.
Oh, wow.
The odds-on favorite.
Wow.
Look at that. We're gonna have to hit the course after this, Wes.
All right, I'll go play.
Well, hey, but Cole, if this happens, if he wins, you have to come in, tell Wes and Joe all about the club fitting, the new driver that you win, your experience from the Arkansas Golf Center.
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Good luck, Cole. Thanks, man. Brian's up next. Brian, what's going on? Brian, oh, sorry.
Get a basketball and grab a golfer.
All right, your golfer is Danny Willett.
I'll take that.
What's your question?
I was just wondering, what do you guys think? Or do you think it's going to be more offensive or defensive forward?
I think if you look at the percentages, Wes, there's going to be a little more offense.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's the game today, as Joe loves to tell me. I like defense. I agree. That when Kentucky was at its best years ago, that's when I thought of Kentucky. I thought about their length, their rebounding, their size, the shot blocking, how hard it was to score against Kentucky. And then they'd get it and go. What was missing out of Kentucky this year was defense. They could score with anybody, but they had a problem stopping anybody, as you saw in the Arkansas game.
I know. Crazy.
We got to take a break. Brian, you got your golfer, right? Yeah.
Hopefully he did.
Yeah, I gave him his golfer. Danny Willett. Yeah, I did. All right. We're rolling over here. And we still got
Danny Willett doesn't have a chance to win.
No.
This is funny. That's funny. Trey doing the breakdown of who has a chance and who doesn't. That's the funniest part.
When did Danny Willett win?
Oh, that was 2000. I don't know off the top of my head. I will say this, and I don't know if you've seen this, guys. Masters.com. You can go and watch every final round of the Masters since 1968.
That is cool.
The broadcast coverage from 1968 until last year, you can go online, sit there, and watch it. Everyone. If you want to sit there and watch 5 hours of last year's broadcast, you can. In 1968, I'm telling you, it wasn't 5 hours. Uh-huh. It was like an hour and 20-something minutes.
Are the commercials in there?
I don't know. I haven't looked at that yet. I thought I would get fired if I did that today while I'm supposed to be working.
Troy says Danny Willett flash in the pan, but he won not too long ago.
He did win.
2016.
There you go.
Oh,
yeah.
I thought it was further.
I thought it was further back, too. Man.
I'd have guessed like 2010.
That's what I was thinking, yeah.
All right, we'll draw some more golfers. We got some people on hold. Stay on hold. We'll take your calls when we come back. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
This is SportsCenter.
Last night, UConn beat Purdue 75-60, winning their second straight national championship. It was a team effort for the Huskies as four players scored in double figures, but they were led by Tristan Newton, who had 20 points, 5 rebounds, and 7 assists. He was named MVP of the tournament after the game. UConn won every game of the tournament by at least 14 points. Their average margin of victory in the tournament was 23.3 points. The last team to complete a back-to-back before them was the Florida Gators in 2006 and 2007. It is UConn's sixth national title, all coming in the last 25 years. They are a perfect 6-0 in the national championship game. And the Arkansas Travelers return to action today. They'll face the Tulsa Drillers with first pitch set for 7 o'clock. Coverage can be heard on 106.7 Buzz 2. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network.
Smell that? Yup, that's the smell of spring, which means it's grass cutting season. And no one cuts grass better than Casey Dacus and Dacus Rental and Sales. It's where Morning Mayhem will be broadcasting live this Wednesday, the next stop on the Gravely Mowers Tour. Stop by and see the guys this Wednesday from 6 till 10 at Dacus Rental and Sales in Searcy.
If you are looking for a safe and loving home for you or your loved one, visit Heartland Rehabilitation and Care Center. Just 15 minutes from Little Rock and Benton, our skilled nursing staff is dedicated to providing quality long-term care and short-term therapy. Visit heartlandrehabcenter.com. You can call Heartland home.
This is Pat Bradley for Brewskies. UFC 300, Saturday, April 13th. Arkansas's very own Bryce Thug Nasty Mitchell will be in the building at Brewskies downtown. Get there early Saturday night and meet the legend himself. Main event features light heavyweight brawl between Alex Pereira and Jamal Hill. And the undercard is loaded. UFC 300, Saturday, April 13th at 9 p.m. Both locations, downtown and north. Meet Bryce Thug Nasty Mitchell in the building at Brewskies downtown. And stick around because the party doesn't stop until 2 a.m. Brewskies, you home for lunch, happy hour, and late night.
It's a good day to be in Arkansas. You know why? The lotto jackpot is now more than $1.5 million. And the best part? The winning ticket can only be sold in Arkansas. Maybe today. Maybe even to you. Can you imagine? There's a jackpot drawing every Wednesday and Saturday night. So your next chance to win is coming up very soon. Try Lotto today for only $2 per play. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
This is the Pigskin Preacher bringing you the word. The world lost a rising star in track at the death of 24-year-old Kenyan Kelvin Kiptum, who tragically died in an auto accident. Kiptum shattered the world record in the marathon last year, running a time of 2 hours and 35 seconds in only his third marathon, a 4-minute, 34-second pace. He almost assuredly would have broken the once unfathomable 2-hour barrier. Kenyan President William Ruto said, "Kiptum was our future, an extraordinary sportsman who left an extraordinary mark on the globe." This young man certainly did make his mark. As we endeavor to leave our mark, take advantage of the convenience, quality, and value of Doublebee's. Doublebee's has the things you need to get through your week. Doublebee's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Doublebee's.
It's Justin Aker from my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Yep, that's the sounds of all my friends and another great deck party of mine. And what do you not hear? That's right, no mosquitoes. That's because Sanders Ground Essential provides me with a monthly mosquito barrier spray. Call them at 315-9395 or on the web at sandersground.com.
I'm a chicken fried, a cold beer on a Friday night, a pair of jeans that fit just right, and the radio. Oh, 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 oh.
It's Out of Bounds. Westmore, Joe Franklin, got Trey Schaap hanging out with us. Talk about the Masters contest to win a driver and a driver fitting. Have you been up to Conway?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a great place. And they've improved it up there. I mean, they've now got some of the TrackMan and Top Golf technology up there, and food and beverage is coming.
Hmm.
So probably by the end of this month, I think they're going to be full go at it.
Big shout out.
And they stay open until late.
Arkansas Golf Center there in Conway.
11:30.
Giving us a
that
driver.
That driver is expensive.
Yeah, well, he told us it was $699.
$599.9. $699
is what he told us. And then the,
oh,
the
yeah,
fitting's
$699,
like $80,
yeah.
$85.
$80,
so
about
like,
with taxes.
Like $700, $800 package.
Yeah.
So, heck yeah. That's awesome.
Yep.
Ro, what's up?
Hey, what's going on? How y'all living?
Good. Man, this is a great week.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, man. Big man in the state over there, Westmore, man. But, no, I was calling. I've been one of the people. I've been saying a lot. The athletic department is broke. They don't have the money. And I still say I was right. But I'm wrong now. And I was wondering. Things go swimmingly in basketball over the next, I say, season or two. How likely are the odds that the other big money donors, like the deep pockets, sit down and say, hey, give us our guy in football and we'll write you this X amount check and we can get football going in the correct direction? How likely is that? Or is that still too political and toxic of a situation?
It's like I said with the Tyson situation, Ro, they got to want to do it. They just don't hand over money. I mean, just because they got money doesn't mean they want to give it away. You know,
yeah,
they've got to want to, and in this case, Tyson wanted to. There's a connection there. You can ask all you want to of someone who has money to give to your cause, and they can tell you no all that they want to. So they have got to be moved in some way or fashion. And maybe, Ro, if you want to say, what if this works out? And someone – like you're talking about, sees this and go, man, maybe that's all it takes. We need to go spend and go spend it on the football program. And it starts maybe a good trend for Arkansas. So maybe it could be a possibility.
Okay. All right. That's all I want to speak. Because I'm just like everybody else, completely out of left field. You know what I mean? And it was one of those coaches like, that's blue blood. You're not going to get him. You know, don't even think in that direction. But then you, hold on. We can pay somebody $8-9 million a year. We can put X amount into an NIL situation. Like, it's possible, but how much do they care about football? That's all I really want to know.
Ro, thanks for calling.
But
it's a good thought.
Yeah, y'all take it easy.
Later, Ro. See you, Ro. Who's coming up on your podcast this week?
So this week I have got back actually last Tuesday from Scotland. Where over there, I sat down with three gentlemen. One was Stuart McComb, who is the executive director of Cabot Highlands up at Inverness, Scotland. One was Robin Dow, who is a historian at Muirfield, which is the home of the Honorable Company of Edinburgh Golfers, which is one of the most difficult golf courses to get on in the world. And then the prized possession, or the prized interview, I guess you could say, was Peter Dawson, former secretary of the RNA and CEO of the RNA from 1999 to 2015. And just a fantastic gentleman that I met last year when I was over there. And we were talking about him coming on my podcast. He couldn't do it then, but he said, stay in touch, gave me his number. And so I stayed in touch with him. And I texted him about mid-January. And I said, hey, Peter, you know, Trey Schapp, you know, from Arkansas, still would like to get you on my golf podcast. And I said, if you're coming to the States, which he is here right now, he's in Augusta for the Masters this week. He was here last week. He actually left last Monday to come here. And he responded, said, not going to be able to do it while I'm in the States. Schedule's too busy, but I have a couple of openings. And he gave me some times and windows and stuff. And when he said, you know, around March the 28th is when we zeroed in on. I was worried about postseason basketball and everything, but my wife and I were able to book some different flights and stuff, and so we were able to make it work and got to go over there and sit down with him, and just a fantastic guy. And I think everybody's really going to like it.
That's cool.
Two episodes coming up with him, and two episodes with Robin Dow, the historian at Muirfield, and then one with Stuart McComb. Those two those two guys will be later on, but Peter starts this week.
Got two clips from him driving into the car park and then playing the old course. Which one?
I think maybe playing the old course first.
And I don't think I've played the old course, although quite a lot of people say this, as well since that first time. Because mm-hmm. you don't know where the trouble is and you're a bit braver with everything and so on. But it's a truly unique golf course and an experience all golfers should have at some point.
An experience all golfers should have at some point.
Yeah.
It is.
What a voice.
It is.
All right.
As secretary of the R&A and chief exec of its companies, I used to drive into the R&A car park when I was in town most mornings. And I got a buzz every day, you know, when I got out of the car. It's real holy ground for golfers here.
Dude, I want to hear the podcast, just listen to him talk for an
yeah.
hour. You know? That's cool.
Yeah, you're going to get to hear him for about 24 minutes in this first episode and about 20... I want to say right at about probably 22, 23 in episode two next week that comes out. But he does have a famous line that everybody that is a golf fan mm-hmm. and especially watches the majors and watches the trophy ceremonies, he does have a famous line that he does say during the trophy ceremony. And I'm just going to say you might hear that in episode two next week.
Mm. Can you tell everybody about the tweet you just put out about 18 minutes
ago? Oh, yeah,
sure.
So, I got this from one of my sources that graphics inside of Bud Walton Arena are up. And I'll just say that what we were talking about, would he ever coach a game in a red jacket? Maybe a white pocket square? Well, that's what's on the walls of Bud Walton Arena right now.
Yeah. Hear how rabid our fans are. There were some fans that were walking around Bud Walton Arena and looked inside the arena and saw that. And they were taking pictures, and you can see that they're standing there at the door in the reflection, and you can see way back there in the background that picture that you have.
Yeah, it's already up.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's exciting right there.
It is my understanding that the announcement will be open to the public.
It's got to be.
Tomorrow, the press conference. Yeah.
If they didn't do that, they would storm
the place. They'd
probably
riot.
Yes, they would find a way in. All right, I'm going to draw a couple golfers real quick. Trimble, you ready? Is it Trimble?
It's Trimble.
Trimble.
I told them they were going to say Trimble. I knew y'all was going to miss the mouth. But, yeah, I just need a golfer.
All right, Trimble, it's Patrick Reed.
Okay, I guess.
He's a past champion.
Hey, well, okay,
it's
Trey.
Hard to root for Patrick
what
Reed.
Do you think, Trey?
It past champion. I think he makes the cut.
Okay, that's all. Hey, that's a start.
That's my handicapping of Patrick Reed this year. I think he makes the cut. I could be wrong. I could be way off.
Another live golfer.
He's the guy you hope misses the cut and breaks a club and. It's hard to root for him, and you got all this on the line. And you're like, God, I got to root for Patrick Reed. Dave joins us. What's up, Dave?
Hey, what's happening, guys? Y'all having a big day, aren't you?
Yes, we are. It is a fun
that's
day.
Exciting. That's exciting. I'm looking forward to that podcast, too. Thanks.
You bet. How about Sergio Garcia?
Another
hey, man, I'll take
champion.
Sergio. Let's go.
All right.
Another
let's go,
past
Dave.
Champion.
Heck yeah. That's
another
excitement
live
I'm looking for.
Yeah. Are the live golfers weighted a little more heavily in your cup?
I don't know. What's the deal?
It's pretty cool.
Eric, what's going on?
Ready to get that golfer, Wes.
All right. I hope you get as excited as our last guy. You got Tommy Fleetwood.
Oh, Fleetwood Mac. I'll take it.
All right.
He's got the long hair. That flow.
When I see the name Tommy Fleetwood, I just think of the hair.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think of his golf game.
No.
I think of the hair. Ray, welcome to Out of Bounds.
Hey, Wes. I was just trying to get a golfer.
I got you one. He's a golfer. He's a little past his prime. You probably wanted him 30 years ago, but I got you. Vijay Singh.
Hey, that works.
All right. Thanks, Ray. I don't know why I put him in the pile. I should put him
you
in the field. You
should put him in the field. Yeah. I don't. He won, what was it? Was he 99? Or early 2000s? I think it was early 2000s when he won. Yeah.
Okay, Carrie's up next. I was writing your name down, Carrie. How do you say
What, you want me to?
No, I know his last name. It's his first name.
Carrie.
No, Carrie. I'm not talking about the golfer. I drew you Thigala. I know how to say his last name.
Oh, Sahith.
Sahith.
Oh, Thigala?
Yeah, Thigala.
Thigala.
You know where he went to school?
No.
Pepperdine.
Nice.
Pepperdine.
Yeah.
The Waves.
Yeah.
That's where your daughter goes to school.
Yeah, so I was like,
it's a great school.
Because, you know, he won not too long ago, and then he was in maybe the final group. He was in, you know, he was in contention. I was like, anybody at Pepperdine talking about him? She's like, I don't know who you're talking about, Dad. I was like,
that's crazy. Yeah.
He's one of your most famous alum right now.
I would say so, especially if he wins a green jacket this year. Yeah, end up being the most famous.
I may bet on him. I may put him in my futures.
You have to.
I bet he's got some pretty decent odds.
Wait till you go to graduation ceremony at Pepperdine University. My niece graduated from Pepperdine a couple of years ago, and just looking out over the Pacific.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's cool.
That's where they do the welcome dinner.
I got to meet Tommy Lasorda.
There?
At the Pepperdine graduation
ceremony.
That's
cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, Carrie, good luck. I hope I do. I hope the Gala wins.
I hope so, too.
Later, man. I watched the Netflix series with the golfers.
Oh, yeah, Full Swing.
Full Swing. And they featured him for a couple episodes. And he and his brother grew up playing golf in their garage.
Isn't that crazy?
Their dad put all these mattresses in the garage and had a little mat, and they would just pound balls in the garage and destroyed the mattress.
I was watching some of the drive, chip, and putt coverage from Sunday, and they would show some of the players that had made it that were like from Colorado, where it's snowing and everything. So what do they do? They hit inside of their garage to keep their swing fluid, and it's all about repetitive motion anyway, but that's what they would do. So, yeah.
Whatever means, whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Got to take a break. We'll try to draw a couple more golfers before we get out of here. Looking at the cup. There aren't many left. We've done a great job. I've tried to hit. Look, you guys are wearing me out on the text line. I'm trying to go through there and pick some golfers for you, but I can't keep up with everybody.
You're going to run out of golfers before you get to
tomorrow.
Tomorrow
may be a short show. We may only have an hour and a half if the Razorbacks play. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
Love off-roading? There's a 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss at Guatney Chevrolet ready for a driver. It's got improved shocks and suspension, plus wheels made for the off-road. You can make it yours for as low as $61,905. Call, click, or come visit Guatney Chevrolet to hear about our available rebates, and we'll make you the boss of the trail. Come see us in Jacksonville or visit GuatneyChevrolet.com. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
This year, we considered hiring an ad agency to help with our marketing.
They pitched impressive visuals and a script that was inspiring.
And exotic animal mascots to help grab your attention.
In the end, we just decided to tell it to you straight. Shelter Insurance has award-winning customer service at affordable rates.
Plus, our local agents are there to help you understand what coverage you need.
See shelter agent Paul Griffin in Monticello, Sam Eklund in Star City, or Kyle Stone in Pine Bluff.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. Hey, everybody, it's RJ Hawk. You know, I've been talking about this for a long time, and I say the future's here. You just haven't tried it yet. If you've got achy joints that have been nagging you for a long time, don't go to a doctor and have them recommend surgery or drugs. Go by and give QC Kinetics a try today for a free consultation. They are the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades. It's called regenerative medicine. If your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. We're talking natural biologics using your own body's power to repair and restore your damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Shinecup. He is a pioneer in the field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. Call QC Kinetics now to learn about these exciting options. It's a free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
Is reviewing life insurance on your to-do list? Now's the perfect time to add it. A friend recently told me that securing life insurance sooner rather than later can help you lock in lower rates for years to come. So I bumped this up on my list and got it done. I called SelectQuote and couldn't believe how easy and affordable life insurance is. I'm 40 and got a $500,000 policy for $16 a month. My husband's also 40, and his $500,000 policy was only $18 a month. Plus, with SelectQuote's same day coverage, there was no medical exam required, and we were covered by the time we hung up. Knowing I have this checked off my list feels amazing, but the peace of mind knowing my family is protected feels even better.
Call SelectQuote at 1-800-670-5151. That's 1-800-670-5151. Or go to SelectQuote.com to get your free quote today. 1-800-670-5151. Details on example rate at selectquote.com.
Forest River RV Little Rock is now open. Come celebrate during our grand opening block party, April 12th and 13th. We'll have food, games, and fun for the whole family. Plus, take advantage of huge grand opening discounts on the top Forest River floor plans. Walk the lot and tour hundreds of new RVs along with a large selection of quality pre-owned RVs. Don't miss the grand opening block party at the all-new Forest River dealership in Little Rock. Learn more at forestriverlittlerock.com/grandopening. We'll see you there.
When you get on a bike, you got to watch out for gravel, potholes, and knucklehead drivers.
But after a crash, here's what you got to watch out for. Insurance adjusters. They can be tough on injured bikers.
They might try to pin the blame on you or pay you less than you deserve.
So if you've been injured, here's what you should do.
Call the lawyers who look out for bikers. That's Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Motorcycle crash? Call Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Anywhere in the state, dial 888-8888. Non-lawyers spoke for
you. Sponsored by attorneys Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
Out of Bounds is back. Raining out there. What do they say? April showers bring May flowers.
That's it.
Yeah. Well, Guatney Chevrolet, it's showers of savings. It's a great time to buy a Guatney Chevrolet. They're making it easy to treat yourself to an upgraded 2024 Chevy Silverado with an off-road performance package, heated leather seats, and more. It can be yours for under $70,000 with 2.9% financing. They've got sedans, the Chevy Malibu for $23,000. That's a great deal. And with spring savings like that, who knows what May will bring? Keep an eye on Guatney Chevrolet to find out. Gregory Street exit in Jacksonville. It's our friends at Guatney Chevrolet. Wes Moore, Joe Franklin. We got two more people on hold, which is good because we're just out of time, about out of time. I hit a couple more people on the text line. Drew a couple golfers for them. And I apologize. Seriously, I'm sorry if I didn't hit you on the text line. Try again tomorrow. It is a lot to keep up with. It's flattering. How many people have called in and texted in? It's good to know there's somebody out there listening. Richard joins us. Richard, what's up? Richard, how are you?
What's up, Wes?
You want a golfer?
Freaky Joe.
Hey.
You bet.
All right.
You bet.
Siwoo Kim. Did I say that right, Trey? Siwoo Kim.
Yes, Siwoo Kim.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's he's your good.
Yeah, he is.
Yep. Hey, love the show. And listen, hey, yeah. Full Swing, man, is awesome.
It is. Yep. Now, have you started season two?
Yes, watch them both.
I have not started season two. Is season two as good as season one?
It is. And then you just want to see more golfers, you know, that go through the show, man. It just makes you want to see more of them, you know, be included in it. But, you know, I don't play.
Yeah.
I do not play. I love watching majors on TV.
Mm-hmm.
My family, you know, they love, and I have, you know, family that loves the game. And but anyway, man, I love it. Siwoo Kim.
Good luck, Richard. Thank you. Yeah, it brings up great memories as a kid. I mean, every Saturday and Sunday, a lot of times we'd play golf, come in and watch the Masters or U.S. Open with my dad and grandfather. Both have passed away since, but you know, those are great memories that I have, and I'm sure I'll reflect on this weekend while I'm watching the Masters. Let's go to Justin. Justin, welcome into Out of Bounds.
What's going on, guys? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well, doing well. Trying to see if I can't go over there to the Arkansas Golf Center. You guys have a good deal going with them.
Yeah, here you go, Justin. You have Lucas Glover.
All right, let's do it.
All right, man, good luck. Thanks for calling. Thank you for listening. Coming up tomorrow, what were you pointing at? Pointing at me. What's trending? What is trending, Joe? You know anything that's trending?
Yeah, there are a few things
besides
out there.
Calipari coming to Arkansas?
Well, UConn won another national championship, and we have some comments from some of the people involved.
What's Trending in Sports is brought to you by Arkansas' own West Rock Coffee. Join West Rock Coffee, the Razorbacks, and their 1.5 million farmers around the globe. It's fall, so now it's time for your team to stock up on coffee, tea, and water delivered directly to your business. Contact them at westrockcoffee.com or 833-886-JAVA today.
What's trending? The Kobe statue that was outside Crypto.com Arena had several errors on it.
Yeah.
And they've now been corrected.
Oh.
So it's good to go on the Kobe statue. And we talked about Robert Dillingham declaring for the NBA.
Yeah.
So
he's not coming to Arkansas?
No. No. He's headed to the NBA.
Okay.
And, of course, like we mentioned, Coach Cal is trending. And so now, you know, we've talked about it, but it's hit nationally where he says that it was just time for another voice. So now he's going to be moving on.
Yeah, Coach Cal put out a video earlier today on Twitter addressing the Kentucky fan base and explaining he just thought, like Joe said, it was time for another voice and he needed to step away from the program entirely. And I think it was very well done. It was a good way to say goodbye. And now he's coming to Arkansas. Everything we're told, it's going to be tomorrow night, 6 o'clock for the press conference, a big pep rally. And also, I am not expecting, I don't think, Trey, I'm not going to speak for you. I'll turn your mic on. I'm not expecting any kind of announcement tonight, just so people aren't hanging
out. It doesn't seem like it.
But yeah. There's nothing to worry about.
None.
Nothing whatsoever to
None.
Worry about.
Whatsoever. No.
Tiger Woods says on the chance of winning the Masters, he says if everything comes together, it'll happen.
I hope it.
Driver, iron,
putter.
Short game, putter.
All has to happen.
And his body has to hold up walking that course for 4 days.
And, Wes, he's got a late tee time to early tee time. So the recovery time for Tiger, will that be a factor? If they get some delays because of weather, would that be a factor?
I haven't looked at the forecast.
Rain Thursday, Friday, I believe.
All right, coming up tomorrow, we have
PB.
Pat Bradley. Maybe a short show due to the Travelers and the Diamond Hogs, but rain could change that too. Stick around. The day's just getting started. Drive Time Sports is next.
Fellas, there's a lot of people out there talking about testosterone, but you got to make sure you do your homework, man. You got to make sure you go to a provider that you can trust. I recommend Low T Center. It's where I got my levels checked 6 years ago, and we're going strong today. At Low T Center, they make it quick and easy. You walk in, you take a simple blood test, and you'll get your results back in about 25 minutes. If you've been feeling tired, grumpy, maybe you've noticed weight gain, loss of muscle mass, you may have low T levels. Go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment online. It's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Let me tell you about my friends, Carl and Karen. This place is sus. Let's go to Tunica. And so they did.